Hello everyone, and peace of Christ to all of you. I hope today we'll have a good time together, and we will learn something new from the ustaz. You know, the ustaz, they have answers for anything you want. If you want to learn about coronavirus, go to the ustaz. If you want to learn why your wife left you, go to the ustaz. If you want to know where the sun set, go to the ustaz. The ustaz, my friend, they are the only one have answers. For sure, after the Prophet. And for sure, after Allah. Allah, the Prophet, the ustaz, the three musketeers. So today we are going to see the three musketeers trying to refute Christian prince, and how a Christian prince is really causing big problem to the Muslims. Now, before we start, I want to give a credit to the brother who translated this video. And this is his channel. If you don't mind, you can subscribe to his channel. Actually, I'm going to post his link so you guys can support him and subscribe to his page. And this is the lowest reward we can do for someone who did a hard job to translate and make the video available in English. So thank you very much, Mr. Cross Plus. The name, how I write it, TM. What TM mean? I don't know. Don't ask me. So anyway, JAWABAN, CERDAS, ATAS, HUJATAN, Christian Prince. That alone is something. I mean, to be honest with you, I never thought that my name will be appear in Indonesia before. Like, my name appear in Mars, because supposedly Muhammad, when he went to the seven galaxies, he took like a coffee in Mars and tea. But Indonesia, I never thought my name would appear there. But obviously the name of Christian Prince is causing big problems. Very big, huge. I mean, literally huge. First of all, let us introduce to you Christian Prince as the Muslim ustaz they see him. Listen carefully.
Sebetulnya, Christian Prince ini keilmuannya tentang Islam dan Kristen sangat dangkal.
Dan I have to agree. The knowledge of a Christian Prince about Islam is very shallow. Extremely shallow. I mean, his ocean of knowledge, you can walk with your 2 feet. You don't need to use a boat. This is how shallow it is.
Senarasi yang ia sampaikan sangat asal-asalan. Dan semua pernyataan-pernyataan atau hujatan-hujatan Christian Prince terhadap Islam.
Hold on. Hujatan. I mean, are you serious? You really? Did you say hujatan? Okay. All his statement, hujatan, and blasphemy from a Christian prince. And the blasphemy against who?
Pernyataan atau hujatan-hujatan Christian prince terhadap Islam, Al-Quran, Nabi Muhammad, dan Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala adalah.
You do blasphemy against Muhammad, why he is God? Those people, they do not know what word blasphemy mean, do you know? Look like they think Muhammad is God. Obviously, they worship him as God.
Lagu lama.
Hold on. What lagu lama? Is that curse or something? What he said? Lagu lama.
Nabi Muhammad dan Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala adalah lagu lama.
Lagu lama. Is that the one that says the same old song? What is that same old song? What is that? Take me with you because I love you so. Don't leave me here, I will draw Picasso. Take me with you, take me with you, because I love you. What is that old song, man? What's wrong with you? Old song? What is that? Are you saying that everybody laughed at Muhammad from long time ago, before even Christian princes exist? I agree. Beautiful song. Continue. Lagu lama.
Sama persis. Persis? Hujatan para missionaris Kristen era tahun 90-an.
Miss what? What Christian, what he did? Man, Christian did it by Christian missionaries. You are talking to one person now. What Christians, missionaries? You think I'm an army or something? Okay, tell us more.
Kristen era tahun 90-an, dan sesungguhnya semua sudah dijawab di dalam buku Ustaz Insan LS Mokoginta yang terbaru.
All of this to promote a book. You see, if you're a friend here, I mean, this guy, he is old and etc. And he is doing da'wah. And if he love Indonesian, who you will go? Christian Prince, he gave his book for the Indonesian for free. Why you don't give it for free? So all of this propaganda just to sell your book? Christian Prince is not Indonesian. He don't speak Indonesian. And the majority of Indonesian are Muslim. Yet he gave his book for free to the Indonesian. Why you don't do the same? Question. Go ahead.
Pembelaan spektakuler mualaf untuk Islam.
Okay, so in this book, guys, you will find any answer you want. Any answer. You know, if you like, why your lips is hurting when you eat spicy food, you will find the answer there. I mean, your guy, he don't even know how to quote a verse in the Quran correctly. And this guy have an answer. In 2 minutes, everybody will be dying laughing at him. And this guy, if this guy, he have a book, I mean, who is left?
Di antara 54 buku bestseller karya beliau, inilah karya monumental beliau yang paling lengkap.
It's commercial for the book.
Memiliki tebal 535 halaman.
Halaman, ya.
Mengumpulkan seluruh jenis hujatan, pelecehan, penghinaan, dan
harassment, insult, and accusation. Harassment. You know, this guy, what is missing is to accuse me of sexual harassment now. What harassment? Okay.
Tuduhan terhadap Islam.
Toward Islam, harassment toward Islam.
Terhadap Al-Quran.
Al-Quran.
Terhadap Allah
Subhanahu wa Taala.
Subhanahu wa Taala. Dan terhadap Rasulullah Muhammad Sallallahu.
Did let me cry. Did he insult the Prophet? You know, you cannot insult the Prophet. The Prophet can insult everybody, but you cannot insult him back. The Prophet, he can call you pigs, he can call you monkeys, he can call you idiot, he can kill you, he can call you kafir, he can call you filthy, dirty, pig, monk, I mean, all names. But you cannot insult the Prophet, but this is disgusting, he's insulting the Prophet. But the Prophet can insult everybody. Yeah, because he's a Prophet, he have a license to insult. He got a license from www.insultasifyouareaprophet.com.
Mengungkap data hinaan sejak tahun 1990 hingga
all of this promoting for it. When that guy will talk, let us skip, man. I'm getting sleepy now. I want to see in the when he will talk. Okay, here we go. Finally, look at this view. See what book make? Not like Christian Prince books are for free everywhere. This guy, he is sitting. He have a servant. He have a leg in the top of the other leg. Uh-huh. Okay. Great business.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Baik, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
I will shave my 20-foot beard if you know how to say the word assalamu alaikum correctly. You and your ustaz. Unbelievable. Anyway, continue.
Alhamdulillah, hari ini kita berada di mana, Ustaz?
Di Gobak Morono, di daerah Kota Mobagu, Sulawesi Utara.
Gobak Morono artinya apa, Ustaz?
Kebun hijau lah kira-kira kita.
Kebun hijau di Kota Mobagu, Sulawesi Utara. Dan akhir-akhir ini kita banyak mendengar dan menyaksikan tentang tuduhan dan pelecehan yang dilakukan oleh Christian Prince terhadap Islam, dan ini cukup meresahkan.
Nah, hold on. The harassment of a Christian Prince causing you problem? Hold on. Did you see that? The harassment of a Christian Prince causing the problem. Okay, what is the problem? Accusation and harassment. You are the one who's making books or videos about me. Who's harassing who? I never know this guy. I mean, look at this. They are the one who's making videos about me, and supposedly I'm the one doing harassment. Unbelievable. Okay, tell us more about the harassment of Christian Prince.
Dan akhir-akhir ini kita banyak mendengar dan menyaksikan tentang tuduhan dan pelecehan yang dilakukan.
Hold on, I did not get this word. Did he say Mexican? Please don't talk about Mexicans, they are my cousins. What Mexican? Leave Mexican alone. One of the best thing Mexican they provide is Corona. Unbelievable, man. I did not drink Corona forever. I got, after more than a year and a half, I did not drink any kind of alcohol. Finally, I got little Corona. You believe it? Unbelievable. Very tasty. Okay, hold on. What?
Kan tentang tuduhan dan pelecehan yang dilakukan oleh Christian Prince terhadap Islam, dan ini cukup meresahkan. Nah, kita akan tanya kepada Ustaz Insan Mokoginta, bagaimana tanggapan beliau?
Mari. Now we are asking the Ustaz, after Christian Prince is causing us all the trouble. I mean, what kind of religion is this religion? A person like me can cause, I mean, who I am? I'm no one. I mean, you know, we are talking about God. God, this God, he is in trouble because of a guy, his name is Christian Prince. I mean, what's wrong with you? Obviously, your God is an idol. Otherwise, he would defend himself. You do not need some potato there and potato here to defend him. Tell us more. Go ahead.
Baiklah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. Uh-oh. He changed the way he talked. This guy, he was talking, saying hi. After I schooled him, I said to him, shame on you, idiot. Don't say hi. What hi? Hi. Say assalamu alaikum. Now he's finally, he starts saying assalamu alaikum. And the funny, they say Christian Prince is not as in salo. An ustaz, and he starts his greeting with hi. Okay, hold on. Let me go back on time. Is it you saying to me here hi? So what happened in the other video? Why in the other video, assalamu alaikum, here hi? By the way, assalamu alaikum is a Christian and Jewish greeting. Have nothing to do with Muhammad. Muhammad is a thief. He stole it. When the angel came to Mary, 600 years before Muhammad, he said to her what? Shalom to you, Mary. When the one they call him angel came to Muhammad, what he said to him? He squeezed him and he said to him, Iqra. Where is shalom? It's gone because this is the devil. You see how you know which one is the angel? How come the angel, he came to Mary, he says to her, shalom to you, Mary. But when the same angel, supposedly according to Muhammad's story, came to Muhammad, he did not say, assalamu alaikum. The guy, he just held him and started squeezing him as if he's a mayonnaise. And no mayonnaise came out. Anyway, this is a different story. We will go back for it. But now, finally, Ustaz, he starts saying, assalamu alaikum, after I schooled him. All right.
Wabarakatuh.
Barakatuh.
Saya Pak Insan LS Mokoginta, saat ini sedang berada di daerah.
I like it when somebody introduce himself. Obviously nobody knows who you are. I am, you remind me of Allah, you know? Allah, nobody know him. So, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, who's talking Allah? Allah saying Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. What? Why you don't say in the name of Insan? Les makagotina. I speak like Allah. If Allah himself, he says in the name of Allah, are you smarter than Allah? Yeah, I never heard of a God says in the name of Allah. I mean, he is Allah supposedly, and then he say in the name of Allah. Huh. Okay. Things happen. I am a Muslim. Can I call? My friend, we need to finish this video first, and then we will see if we can take your calls. After that, we will see. All right, hold your horses, and if you don't have a horse, hold your mule.
Daerah Sulawesi Utara, tepatnya di daerah Blomondo, Kota Mabagu, yaitu di Taman Wisata Bango Murno. Ya, ini cukup indah pemandangannya. Nah, untuk itu, pada kesempatan singkat ini, saya akan menjawab beberapa hujatan, pelecehan, penghinaan terhadap Islam yang dilakukan oleh Christian Prince.
I mean, guys, did you hear the music behind in the background? It's like a horror movie, man. What is this music is about? Did you hear it? Hold on, let me go back. I don't know, maybe you did not notice the music in the background. I mean, this is like a horror movie. Where do you get this music from?
Saya Pak Insan LS Mokoginta, saat ini sedang berada di daerah Sulawesi Utara, tepatnya di daerah Blomondo, Kota Mabagu, yaitu di Taman Wisata Bango Murno. Ya, ini cukup indah pemandangannya. Nah, untuk itu pada kesempatan singkat ini saya akan menjawab beberapa hujatan.
Anyone say to me something, I say to him hujatan. That's it. I speak Indonesian. This is what happened to Muhammad. He learned two Arabic words and he make a Quran, which is the most funny book ever. Okay, tell us more about hujatan. Go ahead.
Christian Prince. Ya, perlu kita ketahui bahwa Christian Prince ini dia tidak pernah menampakkan wajah.
So all this music and buy my book and I will answer to say that Christian Prince, he never show his face. This is the answer you have. You know, you think it's like a volcano is going to explode and then the volcano opened his mouth and what come from there? A mosquito. So all this introduction, by my books have the answer. And then you start saying, Christian Prince, he never show his face. Why? What do you want from my face? What if I don't look good? Don't you see I'm still single? Because each time I ask a woman to marry me, she say, what? There's no man left? Brother? What's wrong with you? Why Muslims are obsessed with my face? What about my foot? What about I expose my shin as Allah, he said in the Quran? I mean, you have no problem that Allah never show his face. You never even saw the face of Muhammad or Jibreel or Mikael or Azrael. But yet you want to see my face. Why? Am I your God? Am I your prophet? Am I Jibreel with the 600 wings? By the way, how Muhammad was able to count them if he saw him for a very fast? Maybe Jibreel, he have numbers over his wings. Number one, number two, number three. He was inspired by the number or he counted them? Maybe he was inspired, maybe. Yeah, but we didn't see that in the Quran, by the way. So how he was inspired? Let it go. So what about my face, Ustaz? This is part of the answer. My face is the problem. My face.
Hujatan, pelecehan, penghinaan terhadap Islam yang dilakukan oleh Christian Prince. Ya, perlu kita ketahui bahwa Christian Prince ini dia tidak pernah menampakkan wajah.
Never.
Kalau dia berbicara hanya suara saja yang muncul. Kalau dia tampakkan wajah.
Stop. When he speak, only his voice appear. That is a discovery. When somebody speak, his voice appear. I mean, what is the connection? It's obvious. Oh, hello. When I speak, what I should? I'm speaking, so my voice will be heard. It's obvious. You just said so. Christian Prince, only when he speak, his voice appear. What does that mean? So what do you want when I speak? What would appear? You know, genius. How you discover that? Nobody noticed that before you, by the way. That when somebody spoke, the voice will appear. And how it appear, by the way? I thought you can hear it. You cannot see it. Can you see my voice? Unbelievable. Tell us more about your wisdom, Prophet Solomon.
Christian Prince ini, dia tidak pernah menampakkan wajah. Kalau dia berbicara hanya
Hold on. I decide to show my face. Hold on. You Muslim, you post pictures all over the internet saying this is me. Suddenly you do not know, show my face. So who is that guy you post there? That's mean it's obviously you are lying to your people saying this is me and it's not me. So either it's me or it's not. Hello? Hold on, let me find that. I know many of you will be shocked when you see my face now. I have to show you now my face. Okay. What we can do? I mean, we have to show the face. Otherwise, the Muslims are unhappy. All right. Yeah. Brother. I will see if that will work because I want them to stop saying they don't show his face, he don't show his face. I'm sick of this, man. Brother, I'm very handsome, very good looking, and my real name is Ahmadinejad. Now, let us say, okay, you saw my face now. Look how, man, how good looking I am. After you saw me, now what? Do you have the answer? You don't have the answer. You see my face, you don't have the face, you don't know my answer. Where is the answer? What my face have to do with your answer, man? And look now, they, look the number of people who they were watching the video, they are going. Look, I used to have like, and guys, why we have a small number? Where is everybody? We have only 1,130 people watching after I put my picture for you. It should be two people leave. That's mean me and the admin. The rest should leave right away after they see my face. Which, why Muslims are obsessed with my face? Okay, now here we go. All the ladies will leave. Nobody will come back. Oh boy. We thought Christian Prince, you know, reality. Here we go. Reality check. Are you happy now? Are you happy? Every Muslim want to debate me, want to see my face. I want to debate you face to face. What about shoulder to shoulder? No. Nose to nose? No. Face to face. I challenge you, face to face. Okay. We go back. From now on, you can dream about my face as long as you're obsessed with my face, my buddy. I mean, you have a problem. Really, you have a problem with his face. Every video he go, he says, face Christian Prince. He go to sleep, face Christian Prince. Where is your face? Show me your face. Okay. He speak only his voice appearing. Aha. What a discovery.
Prince ini, dia tidak pernah menampakkan wajah. Kalau dia berbicara hanya suara saja yang muncul. Kalau dia tampakkan wajah itu menggunakan masker ya, penutup wajah.
Masker. I learned another word in Indonesian. So masker is mask. Okay. Masker, where are you? Shame on Muhammad, shame on you. You spend half of the video talk about my face. I will make you barbecue. Masker, where are you? You idiot. People are waiting for the answer, background music, horror movie, a guy standing, interview. People think this is serious, and now you are talking about a masker of a Christian Prince vase. Give us the answer, man. Oh boy. Masker. So if we add the, in Indonesian, if we add like roni at the end, mascaroni, does that make it like pepperoni? Because I like mascaroni in the taste of pepperoni. Continue, Abdul.
Jadi hanya suara saja dan tidak pernah terlihat langsung siapa orangnya. Really? Tapi hujatan dia terhadap Islam, Allah, Al-Quran, dan sebagainya itu sudah terlampau amat meresahkan, bahkan sudah menghebohkan.
Hold on. Finally, the truth is coming. Cause us troubles, even ratio. Did you see what happened? I mean, Christian Prince without face causing you trouble, a ratio. So what if he show his face? What will happen? Look at this. Look, I want to see it again. What Christian Prince he caused you?
Dan sebagainya itu sudah terlampau amat meresahkan, bahkan sudah menghebohkan dunia.
In the world. This guy, he did not show his face and he caused trouble, a ratio in the world. Oh boy. Ta-da-da-ta-da-da-ta-da-da. Without his face, he caused ratio in every place. Without his face. He is working in Qur’an erase. Without his face, equals ratio for us. Without his face, Islam disappear everywhere. What is that, man? I cause ratio and trouble for all the world without showing my face. What if I show my nose, my ear? Can you imagine the impact of such a behavior? Tell us more. All right. Go ahead.
dan tidak pernah terlihat langsung siapa orangnya. Tapi hujatan dia terhadap Islam, Allah, Al-Quran, dan sebagainya itu sudah terlampau amat meresahkan, bahkan sudah menghebohkan dunia. Nah, menurut saya Kristen Prince ini itu orang pengecut.
Is that kawan?
Kristen Prince ini.
Oh, by mistake we click at that. I mean, we broke it now. By mistake we, you know. Kristen Prince is a coward. Kristen Prince is a coward. Okay.
Itu sudah terlampau amat meresahkan, bahkan sudah menghebohkan dunia.
Dunia? Nah,
menurut saya, Kristen Prince ini itu orang pengecut.
Why? Why a coward? Please explain to us. Please, brother, explain to us why Kristen Prince is a coward. My friend, if I sneeze, I will make you fly. Honestly. So what does that have to do with coward? We are talking about talking. We are not fighting by the sword, you idiot. What coward? What's wrong with you? You just said a second ago, this guy, he don't show his face, and you Muslims in the around the world in trouble. You have ratio between you. A lot of Muslims leave in Islam. And now you are saying he's a coward. Why, what do you want me to do? Take jihad, do jihad, take a sword, come to you, brother. No, brother, I don't do that. You are an old man, and I don't do kill people. I'm a very peaceful person, by the way. Kristen Prince is a coward. What does this have to do with the answer? You know what? You are the brave. You are Sylvester Stallone. In the movie, it's called what? JAWABAN, CERDAS, ATAS, HUJATAN, Christian Prince, KEPADA, Al-Qur’an, TENTANG, LUMPUR, HITAM. Okay, this is the name of the movie. I mean, this movie is very, the name is so. By the time you finish reading the name of the movie, the movie is over. And with this, what is the answer, man? People are waiting.
Kenapa pengecut? Dia tidak pernah menampakkan wajah.
He never showed his face.
Dia tidak mau berdebat langsung secara face.
We challenge him for debate face to face. Face to face. He invited me even to Indonesia, brother. I mean, Abdul, you see, everybody knows. Everybody is laughing at you. Because what about you call me in Skype? What face to face mean? And secondly, you know, everybody would not only knew that you are stupid and you are a coward. You are the coward. Because if you have the courage really to face me face to face, you don't have the courage to speak to me in Skype. I mean, how come you have courage? Because you know that face to face is impossible. If I go to Indonesia, they will kill me in 2 seconds. You are a coward. You are the coward. You are the coward who is avoiding using any excuse. All of you, those who say want to do face to face, are cowards. Not me. Because people are interested in the answers, not in your face. Here we go, we see your face. Look at this. Chaos, ratio, trouble around the Muslim world, and no answer. Is the answer coming? Or you will spend the whole day speaking about my face? You know what? I wonder now how many ustaz in Indonesia, when they go to the park like this, and there's a lake next to them, and there are 4 wives around them, and there's 70 slaves around them, and then instead of thinking about the women around them, and the food, and the wine which Allah will provide in heaven, they are thinking about Kristen Prince. What is your face, Kristen Prince? A coward, Kristen Prince. Face, show us your face. Face, show us your face. So show us your face. Hey, you cannot answer me with my with face, without face. Still, you cannot answer me. Everybody will laugh at you in the community. You see, the second they start answer is the same second poo-poo start coming out of their mouth. Listen carefully. Until now, he did not answer, by the way. He just blah, 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 because he's a coward. And by the way, insan, if you're already brave, call me and do live debate. And you know what? Open challenge. I will not ask you a question. You give me the question to ask you. What do you think, guys? Look how easy the challenge. You say to me, Christian Prince, ask me this question. This is the easiest exam ever. Imagine the teacher, he say to you, when you go to school to do exam, ask yourself the question and answer it. And if you pass, you are good to go. You will not pass, even if you are the one who gave me the question to ask you. Continue.
So it's terbuka. Ya, menurut saya Kristen Prince ini ilmunya juga sebenarnya cetek. tidak seberapa.
I mean, how many times in this video you say the Christian prince knowledge is shallow? Like, I mean, come on. You remind me of Allah. You know, Allah, he says, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Less than a second after he say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Already you said that, and then a second after, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Oh, hold on, you remind me of something in the Quran. Oh boy. Shall I go there? Brother, I have to go there. I have no choice. Excuse me. You remind me really of Allah. Look at this. Wisdom. Wiz and Don, put them together. They are priceless. Oh boy. Okay. If you read the Quran, you will notice that the Quran is nothing but repeated words. There is nothing there. This book is empty. All the verses are the same. All the verses. And I will show you some example. Like actually, all of those are example, you know. Let us see. Oh boy. All of those. Look, 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 look. How many? Look, 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 look. But let us make it fast. Hold on. I will copy this sentence in the Quran and I will search in one page. How many times the Quran repeat the same thing? Oh boy. Oh mommy. Oh mommy, mommy blue, oh mommy blue. To be honest with you, it's yellow. Oh mommy, mommy blue, oh mommy blue, blue, blue and yellow. Oh mommy, mommy blue, oh mommy blue. I mean, do Allah have anything to say to us? No, empty, you know, empty head, he has nothing to say, he repeat the same. And then which in the favor of your Lord you will deny, which in the favor of your Lord you will deny. This is God. This is my grandma after she became 125 years old after the first 17 years of her life. What is this, man? This is God talking? What is this? The same sentence all over, over. Oh, mommy. Okay, now we go back to a teacher who keep repeating his knowledge is shallow. His knowledge is shallow. We got it. We got it. His knowledge is shallow. Hello? I mean, isn't it obvious? What's wrong with you? All Muslims, they got it already. You sound like Allah now. Very boring. Okay. And how embarrassing. Exactly.
Menurut saya, Christian Prince ini, ilmunya juga sebenarnya cetek. Tidak seberapa, sangat memalukan, masih sangat lemah pemahaman dia terhadap Quran maupun Alkitab. Banyak hujatan tuduhan dia yang selama sekali hanya ngarang-ngarang aja. Tapi ini berbahaya bagi orang Islam.
It's fabrication, but it's dangerous for Islam. Man, it's fabrication, but it's dangerous for Islam. Okay, let's see who is fabrication what.
Alkitab. Banyak hujatan tuduhan dia yang selama sekali hanya ngarang-ngarang aja. Tapi ini berbahaya bagi orang Islam awam. Contoh, katanya Al-Quran itu nggak mungkin wahyu Allah. Kenapa kok Allah berfirman katanya matahari terbenam di lumpur yang hitam? Masa matahari terbenam di lumpur yang hitam? Nah, ini ternyata di sini pemahaman dia sangat keliru. Yang mengatakan bahwa matahari terbenam di lumpur hitam itu bukan Allah tapi adalah Zulkarnain. Zulkarnain pada saat itu dia...
Zulkarnain is the one who said that the sun set in murky water. Are you sure, brother? Now the answer is coming. Finally, after all this like propaganda, guys, just to show you, that the second you follow Islam, literally you lose your mind. Note with me what he said. Listen carefully. Muslims, I want the Muslim to listen before the Christians, especially Indonesians. Listen carefully.
Benam di lumpur yang hitam. Masa matahari terbenam di lumpur yang hitam? Nah, ini ternyata di sini pemahaman dia sangat keliru. Yang mengatakan bahwa matahari terbenam di lumpur hitam itu bukan Allah, tapi adalah Zulkarnain.
It wasn't Allah, it was Zulkarnain. Okay, I will go to the previous video just to show you that this guy is stupid. This is the same topic. He was refuting me about this. This is the same guy. Isn't him the same guy? Look, let me look. Yeah, it's the same face. I don't know, but he's looked like a rooster now. He is like standing up because suppose this is official, not in the park. Okay, tell us what happened with Zulkarnain. Go ahead, I'm listening.
I really hope he will realize his mistake and foolishness that he...
I just did, just to let you know, honestly. Thank you very much. I appreciate your help. Before your therapy, I was lost. And now I saw light.
Convey through social media. Hopefully, Muslim and Christian viewer won't easily believe what he says because his knowledge of Quran and the Bible actually is still low.
Hold on. He changed it. He did not say shallow. That's a good point. Finally, he did not say shallow again. I'm sick of it. Low. Okay, that's better.
By following our video, at least you will have more knowledge and insight
for sure
about Islam and Christianity.
Absolutely.
And about Quran and the Bible as well.
Mm-hmm.
Christian Prince said that Quran wasn't a God's revelation because according to him, it was impossible for the sun to set in the black mud.
What do you mean impossible? I never said it's impossible. If you live in Iraq, Saddam Hussein will make you believe that the sun set, you like it or don't. If you live in Saudi Arabia, the king of Saudi Arabia will make you believe the sun set in the murky water, you like it or otherwise they will chop your head. Who said it's impossible, man? It's not impossible, especially for Allah. Are you saying it's impossible for Allah to make the sun set in murky water? You are making blasphemy now, brother.
It's written in Al-Kahfi, verse number 80.
It's not Al-Kahfi, it's Al-Kahf. Al-Kahf, you idiot. Not Al-Kahfi. Okay.
Six. The accusation that Christian Prince made really prove his...
Did you just touch your ear when you said the accusation? Why you touch your ear? Huh? Why? This is called body language. Liar. Uh-huh. Yeah, start touching ears and nose. Oh, okay. Go ahead.
Foolishness. Or without he realized he was... revealed his own lies and foolishness. It proved that he didn't read the Quran, Al-Kahfi verse
Al-Kahfi again.
86 correctly. Well, he knew it, but deliberately translated it
deliberately.
As
I have to agree with you. This is a word very hard for me to say. Deliberately. I did that? Okay, how is that? Explain to us. Go ahead.
He lied. So that Muslim doubt their holy book. I will quote the Al-Kahfi first.
Finally! This is the same as Allah. Blah, 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 blah. And now the answer. Why you give us the answer in 2 seconds? What is this about? Instead of bashing me, speaking about me, what's wrong with you, man? Leave the Christian Prince alone.
86.
Oh, wait. Muslims, I want you to listen what he will say. what he will say. This is in the minute 342 in the video here, and we will go back and we will play what he said here, because you will see how he get himself busted, the idiot. He said here that Allah is not the one is talking, it was Alexander the Great.
Lumpur hitam itu bukan Allah tapi adalah Zulkarnain. Zulkarnain pada saat itu dia sedang memimpin pasukan.
Okay, let us go here and you will see how we will see the opposite.
Until when he reads the setting of the sun.
You either did you say until he? Guys, did he say until he? So how Alexander the Great is the one is talking and then he said, the verse says, until he reached the setting place of the sun. Alexander the Great, he said, until he. Read it again, brother.
Until when he reads the setting of the sun.
Stop. The Quran saying that Alexander the Great said, until he reached the setting place of the sun. So Alexander the Great, when he talk, he says, until he reached the setting place of the sun. Okay, Alexander the Great is talking now. Who is he? I mean, do you see how stupid you are? You know, Abdul, listen, Abdul, honestly, if I leave my toes alone in a room, have like 1,000 Muslims, he can debate you, my toes alone. By the way, don't misestimate my toes, you know? I just, you know, killed a spider. You know, I found him in the backyard. He looked at me and looked like, he said, I am the one who protect the Prophet. Yeah, the story of the spider, which we cannot find it anywhere. It's a big fake hadith, the Muslim, they keep repeating it everywhere. But anyway, brother, so until he reached the setting of the sun, who is he and who is talking? Potato?
He found it is in...
Did he say he found it again? Did you just say he found it? So Alexander the Great is the one is talking. Alexander the Great is saying, and he found it. So I am Alexander the Great, and I am talking now, and I say, and he found it. Unbelievable. You want to debate Christian Prince? Are you sure? My friend, I will not even dare to debate myself. I will lose. Trust me. Muslim, do you see how stupid this one you call him teacher? This is his translation. Hold on. I will take a snapshot so this is it will not be in front of us. And we will put it in the screen so we can read the text correctly. Clearly, I mean.
Setting of the sun, he found it is in a spring or murky water near it.
Okay, hold on. And again he said near it. He near it what?
He found it is in a spring or murky water. Near it he found a people.
Okay. I will stop here. What we heard now, this Abdul, he is not only getting his God busted, he is getting himself busted with no mercy. Until he, what? I will post the translation again of what he said, not what I said. Near it, he found, let us make it big. Most of you guys are very old like me and you cannot see very good vision. Near it, he found people. Okay, how the one is talking is Zulqarnain, and it says near it he found people. Indonesian people. Which one is the word he in the Indonesian language here, in the white line? Which one is the word he in the Indonesian? Somebody can tell me, please. The one who tell me first, I will grant you. The first visit to heaven of Allah and a lot of wines made in Kuala Lumpur. Dia? Okay, Dia. Let us see where is the. Oh, it says Dia here. Look, 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 look. Even here it says Dia. Hello? Abdul, this is your translation. You are officially certified idiot, trying supposedly to refute me, but look what you did. Very horrible, brother. Very horrible. You said in your translation, dia, he who, if Zulqarnain is talking, then the Quran should not say he. He found people. So the one is talking is who? The reporter. Who is the reporter? Allah. Allah is the reporter. Actually, we will go to the Quran and we will show the Muslims how this fool is trying to fool you. So until now, Alexander the Great is not talking, obviously. Because if Alexander the Great is talking, he will say, and I found people, not he. I mean, it's obvious. You do not need to be genius, right? Very simple. So, he found people. Let us see the verse after it. The verse after it saying, and let us zoom in to make it more big. He found it. He found it, and here it says dia again. Dia, he found it. So who's talking? Allah. See, Muslims, how he fooled you? If Alexander the Great, he said, he's the one who's talking, he says, I found it sitting in a spring of murky water. The one who's talking, obviously, it's not Alexander the Great. For he is not talking, obviously, from the language. It says he. And actually, if you go in the Quran, just to show you that this guy is an idiot, he do not know how to read his book. If we go in the Quran, you will see in chapter 18, verse number 86, let us go to that. Indonesian translation. Look what it says. You are Indonesian, you speak Indonesian, right? I'm assuming so. Hello. In verse number 83, it says they are asking you about Zulqarnain. I will tell you something of it. Who is the one who's talking? Allah. Zulqarnain is already dead. So they are asking Muhammad about Zulqarnain. So Allah said to Muhammad, they are asking you about Zulqarnain. I will tell you some of his story. So who is the one who's talking in verse number 83? It's so clear, it is Allah. All right. Now, if we take this verse here, I made a list of translations, so Indonesian with me, they can see what we are talking about. This is Google Translation. All right. We have here in the left, the verses in the Indonesian language, in the as it's translated by the Muslims, remember. As it is translated by the Muslim. This is not my translation. This is verse number 83. Okay, here is 83. We are typing in Arabic, all right. And then we need to add, and here is 84, etc. So look what happened here. This is the Indonesian translation confirmed to us that Allah is the one speaking. Allah is the one is speaking. Until he found it sitting in a murky water. Who is the one who found it? Zulqarnain. Who is the one is talking? Allah. This is why it says dia, he found it sitting in murky water. So this liar, he's trying to fool you, avoiding my previous video. You guys remember my video? I made a video about this, and supposedly he's trying to refute me, right? So how come he did not mention what his prophet said? We will go to that part later. So this mad person, he is trying to defend falsely, and the more he defends, the more he will make mistakes, because it's obvious the one is talking is Allah. And if Allah, he says he found the sun sitting in murky water, there's no way that it's he's saying he thought the sun sitting in murky water. There's a huge difference between he found and he thought. He found, if I say to you, this guy, he went and he found his father dead. If the father was not dead, then I will not say he found his father dead. I say he thought his father dead. Very easy. Because now, because supposedly his father did not die. So, but if the father was dead, so we say he found his father dead, not he thought his father dead. So Allah never said the word thought. And when we say Allah here, we are speaking about Muhammad, because Muhammad is the one fabricating this Quran. Allah and Muhammad is one. So this is your translation. It says here, indeed we have given him power. Who is talking? Allah. Verse number 84. Indeed we gave him power. Who is the one gave power? Allah. Then Allah continues saying, then he took a road, you know, different direction. He followed a road. Verse number 85. And look how the verses became so long in translation. And then, and after he took the road, until when he came to the setting of the sun. You see, the one is talking now is Allah. Until he came to the setting place of the sun. Okay, until he came to the setting of the sun. So why you are lying, saying the one who's talking is the Qur'an? You have no respect to yourself. Until he arrived to the setting place of the sun, there he found it sitting in a spring of muddy water. It's not even a sea. There he found next to it people. And then after that, supposedly Allah, he report a conversation between him and Zulqarnain. So he said to him, after he found the sun sitting in murky water, after that, and he found people next to it, then Allah saying, we said to him, until now Zulqarnain is not talking. Then we said to him, after he, you see, he, Diya again. So he found the people next to it, and then we said to him, O Zulqarnain, either you punish them or do good to them, which is a very stupid statement. I mean, what does that mean? Is that a game? Punish them or do good to them? How he will, why he is punishing them and doing good to them in the same time? And what kind of a choice this choice is? If they are bad, they are bad. If they are good, good, good. And then, and now Zulqarnain, supposedly is entering the conversation. Here you see how this person tried to fool you, saying Zulqarnain is not talking. I will go back to his video a little bit so we can see more of his smart answers, for they are laughable and they are our comedy. Actually, I enjoy talking about this guy. He's the best comedy, you know. And after Muhammad, for sure. I don't want Muhammad to be upset from me and say, oh, you replace me now with this guy. I mean, we have to remember the number one comedian is Muhammad, because he is the one who discovered where the sun set in the murky water. Yeah. I'm drinking cocoa now. Do you think the sun is there? Because it's very muddy and murky. It's looked like literally like a muddy water now. Literally. Cocoa.
Bukan, dia berjalan sampailah dia pada satu di ujung laut. Sudah tidak bisa meneruskan perjalanan.
Until he reached the edge of the sea. Guys, where is the word sea? Where is the word sea in the Quran? You liar. You know what? I have a challenge for you. I like it. Put your hand up. Yeah, look at this hand, man. His hand is up. The sea. The edge of the sea. There's edge of the sea. Okay. He reached the edge of the sea. But in Arabic, we don't see the word sea. Muslims, Indonesian, I will do this in front of you. I will take this verse. Actually, we translated, right? Already we translated that, but I'm going to take the Arabic this time. حتى إذا بلغ مغرب الشمس وجدها تغرب في عين حمية. Now, Google translation might not give a correct translation, but we will try it. Let us go here. And we will post the verse as it is in Arabic in the front of your eyes. And we will translate to Indonesian language. Switch. And here we need to change the language to Arabic. Okay, here we go. Now we have it in English. Any of you Indonesian people see the word? Let me, if I make the page wider, maybe that will make it. Let me make it small text. I don't know why my page is messed up as I look. Okay. Yeah, but this is in the Indonesian translation. But in the real translation, there's no C. See, this is the Arabic word as it is. And this is Google translation. Anyone can show me where it says the word C here? Muslims, did you ask yourself, why the word C disappear? It says here, Dimata Hamia. I don't know what dimata mean, but ayn is a spring of water. How we can prove that ayn is a spring of water? Very simple. Ayn is a word mean eye. You see it? Qurratu ayni is like the ball of my eye. Like the, I protect it with as because this is hurt. This is my eye, the one I can see with it. All right? But here, if you go in chapter 34, verse number 12, you will see the word ayn appear clearly. It says here, aynul qatr. What is the aynul qatr? It is spring. It's a spring. I don't know where the word is spring here in the Indonesian translation, but it should appear. Anyone can tell me which one? Laut, right? Laut is a sea. Which one is mata? Okay, mata. So mata here. Let us go to the Indonesian translation, chapter 34, verse number 12. Mata air. Indonesian, here we go. All right. So here it says, what is the word ayn? Mata air. No, this is in the translation there. Here, this is this verse. In the verse of chapter 34, verse number 12, it should say ayn. What is the word ayn? Which one? Sama, Yang, Badi, I don't know which one. But if we take it here, let us do this. Let us take this part and translate as long help is not coming. Yeah, but I don't see the word Mata Air here. Where is the word Mata Air? Is it showing here in this verse? I think you guys, you have a very, very delay. We're talking about chapter 34, verse number 12. Do you see the word spring? No word of I, right? Okay. Yeah, but if we go, if we change the translation, hold on. From Indonesian, let us say to, let's go back to English. I don't see it too here. But just to make it simple, hold on. Yeah, translation is funny, but let's make it simple for everybody. Give me a second. We will open the translation or the interpretation of the verses, and you will see how they lie in the this is why I say always to you, you cannot take Islamic translation as a Quran. Even the Muslim, by the way, don't accept it as a Quran because it's full of lies. Most of those translation is made to sell this Islam to us, to make Islam look better, look without mistakes. So here we go, chapter 34, verse number 12. I will read it for you on screen. I'm just finding the interpretation. All right. Here we go. See, this is the correct translation should be. Here, the word Ain is coming as the fount flowed, the fount of Milton Cooper. Do you see it? You see the word Ain? In the English translation and in the Indonesian translation, the word Ain translation disappear. There's no spring, there's no fount. This is what Ain mean. Ain is a spring of water, a fount of water, anything where water is coming, bursting out of the ground. All right? So the same word, it's appear for us in the Quran here as the same word appear in the chapter of the cave, Ain. You see it? This is exactly the same word. And the translation, and this is the interpretation saying clearly, it is a fount. And this is the Seer al-Jalalain. So Muslim cannot say, oh, this is false, this is, doesn't say that, this is not. So this is what the word Ain mean. It's a spring of water, a fount of water, little tiny water. And here he is, the Quran using it as a fount of copper, which is very funny. So a fount of any liquid, it is Ain. And it can mean in the same time an eye. This is why they call it the fount of water or spring of water, they call it eye too, because it's so small, like the eye. It's like a hole in the ground where water, a spring of water is coming out. It's not a river. It's not a big, huge amount of water or liquid coming. So this is what Ain mean. And this is the same use for Huru Ain, supposedly speaking about the eye of those virgins who the Muslims will have an endless penis to sleep with them. So when this guy, he tried to explain the Quran, he avoided clearly, even in his translation, if we go here, you will see, and this is the good thing about those Muslims, they always help us to get them busted. If we go back here, in the translation of this guy, you will see, even in his translation, it says the word Ain. And the translation in his video appear as a spring of water. Read carefully.
Until when he reached the setting of the sun, he found it is in a spring or murky water near.
See, we heard him and he said, and the translation even in English saying clearly, he found it in a spring of muddy water. So why he was saying to the Muslims in the video that he reached the edge of the sea, when even in his translation in the previous video, he said a spring of water. You see it? How a spring of water became an ocean? And I believe strongly, this is the reason this guy, this time he did not make his answer for me in English. Because he found it very embarrassing, the stupid mistakes he do. He helped me to expose how he lie. by using his own words to get him busted. He cannot say, I did not say that. It's in a video published by him in his webpage. Spring of muddy water. It's a spring. So here in the Indonesian translation, they say lout. What lout? Where is the word lout is coming from? That is a false translation. Do you see the contradiction? Here it says a spring. Here it says lout. The correct one is a spring. And I change any Muslim to say I'm lying. Actually, I encourage all the Indonesian to do as I did. Go to your Quran, open the same chapter, very simple, very easy, and copy the verses, chapter 18, verse number 86, and post in Google Translation. Just copy it as it is, and translate. And let us see if the word see will appear. If there's no word see, it means they are lying. There is no word see. This is Google Translation. We will do it again in front of you. I will pause the text and Google will do the job. Now, Google is not perfect, but it helps us. Where is the word see? We don't see it. Right? Do we see the word? No. What we see here, the matter, which I understand mata mean a spring, right? A spring of water. You see how easy to get them busted and they are lying to you? Very simple. So obviously the Quran is made by a stupid idiot. His name is Muhammad. He is copying a story, is written by a person from Syria. And by the way, the person who wrote the story about Alexander the Great, he's a Christian. He's a Christian, but this is a fiction story. It's like now you write a story about Hercules. Hercules is a real person. But the story, fiction stories about him, they add stuff, you know. So they use like historical time or historical person. And this person, everybody knows his story is fiction. It's just for fun. Muhammad the idiot, he took the story from this guy and he put it in the Quran, claiming that Allah told him this. The Jews, they came to Muhammad, they asked him, tell us about Zulqarnain. Tell us about Zulqarnain. How we can discover why actually this story is happening. It says here, and they are asking thee concerning Zulqarnain. They are asking thee. Did you ask yourself who is the one is asking him? The Jews are making fun of Muhammad. Because this guy, you give him a bone, he starts chewing in it. So they give him a bone. And he make a story about it so they can laugh at him. So they are asking, he said, give me time to answer you. And then Allah, he says, Allah inspire me. Let us see the interpretation for this verse. Who is the one is asking him about Zulqarnain? Let us go. Chapter 18, verse number 83. Idiot, just ask him a question. He cannot say I do not know. He have to open his mouth and says, you know, shish kebab hummus. And the second he start talking, is the same second people start laughing. Say anything? Let us go to Al-Jalalain. Actually, it says the Jews. Hold on. Hey, here we go. You see, it says the Jews. As I say, the Jews, they ask him a question. Who is Zulqarnain? Just to be sure that this guy is a filthy false prophet. Zulqarnain is a homosexual and he is a bisexual. How in the world he became a prophet of God? So the Jews say, let us ask him a simple question. In 2 seconds you will see that this guy is a liar. Let us ask him about Zulqarnain. Suddenly Zulqarnain became a prophet of Allah. Here, look, it says in Al-Jalalain saying, whose name was Alexander, he was not a prophet. I say recite relating the Quran, say clearly Allah, he spoke to him and he said to him, if they are doing good, punish them. If they are bad, it's up to you. So Allah is giving command to him. So he is not, if he is not a prophet, he's what? Change interpretation. Ibn Abbas. The people of Mecca will ask, O Muhammad, in the event of Zulqarnain, say to them, Muhammad, I shall recite to you a remembrance of him, explaining his event. The guy, he said to us that the one is talking is not Allah, it is Zulqarnain. Not long time ago, there was a king, a very famous king, and I said to you, tell us who is the king. And then I start saying he is sent by Allah, and Allah gave him power, and you know, he accomplished. So when this guy trying his best to refute us, he is helping us to refute Muhammad. And here, by the way, if you are an Indonesian, you are going to make a video, you do not need to post all my video. Make it, you can make it short, you can cut and make it simple. I mean, you can make it 5 minutes if you want. Between his answer, my answer, take the most important, put them together and make a short video for a short translation. But don't miss the important point, please. So let us finish.
Sangat lemah pemahaman di orang Islam awam. Contoh, kata benam di lumpur yang hitam. Nah, ini ternyata di sini pemahaman dia sangat keliru. Yang mengatakan bahwa matahari terbenam di lumpur di ujung laut sudah tidak bisa meneruskan perjalanan sementara matahari sudah hampir terbenam. Karena matahari sudah di ufuk timur sudah hampir terbenam, ya sehingga air laut itu terlihat hitam. Jadi matahari seperti terbenam di lumpur yang hitam, ya hilang. Karena sudah gelap. Nah, dia mengatakan bahwa matahari terbenam di lumpur yang hitam. Itu tidak mungkin matahari terbenam di lumpur hitam. Itu maksudnya matahari terbenam seperti di lumpur yang hitam. Tapi yang mengatakan itu bukan Allah.
Yeah, it's not Allah. It's not Allah who said that. You know what? I will give you a spring of water in your bum. So you can wash it because you have a lot of poo there and people will laugh at you. This is your prophet saying that. Are you saying that your prophet is a fabricator too? I want the Muslims to tell him why you are stupid, why you are insulting your prophet, because he just said it's impossible that Allah will say that. And he said, read with me carefully, Muhammadan. And if he wouldn't say to you, this is da'if, it's not da'if as you see. This is the reference in the front of you. This is your Muslim website. This is not da'if. So what Muhammad said? I was sitting behind the messenger of Allah who was riding a donkey while the sun was setting. Guys, if you are losing my connection, you can watch it later. YouTube will find. We lost connection. Connection is coming back. All right. Yeah, in case you lose connection, please refresh the page. And however, I believe strongly that YouTube still will preserve the recording and later you will have the full video, maybe a few disturbed here and there. Now, read with me carefully. I was behind the messenger of Allah who was riding a donkey while the sun was setting. He asked, do you know where this set? I replied, Allah and his apostle know best. He said, it set in a spring of warm water. Muddy hot water. Why you are lying saying there's an ocean and the edge of the ocean, and he saw the ocean as if it's disappearing in the ocean, when in the Quran never says he thought it disappear, it looked like maybe it is. Why you Muslims are fabricating things just to defend the stupidity of your prophet? Nowhere in the Quran it says what you are saying. And here we go, this is your prophet getting you busted. And you are the one who say, the one who says such a thing is a fabricator. The one who say that the sun sitting in murky water, according to the Quran, is a liar. That means you just called your prophet a liar. You just agreed that Muhammad is a fraud because it is your prophet who say so, not me. Are you going to say your prophet is a liar? I want all the Muslims who are listening. Say to him, how come you made 2-3 videos about the same topic, but still you are not answering Christian Prince? Isn't it your prophet who said that too? Was he a stupid? Was he a fabricator? Because in his video he said, the one who says such a thing is a fabricator. For the Indonesian, so they will see, but I will change not to English, I will change to Indonesian. And now what we will see both will be translating to Indonesian. Choose another language. We choose Indonesian. Where is the Indonesian? I didn't see it. Japanese. Here we go. All right. Translate. All right. This is your Indonesian translation, my friend. Translating the Arabic as it is and translating the English it was in the left. So here you will see that the Prophet was sitting behind. A guy was sitting behind the Prophet. His name is Abu Dharr. He's a very well-known companion who used to accompany Muhammad like Abu Huraira for the sake of food, free food. Those are the cats of the town. They accompany the big dog so they can get some meat. So it says here that I was riding behind the Prophet and he said to me, do you know where the sun set during the sunset? I said, well, Allah and his apostle knows best. And then Muhammad, he said, it set in a spring of hot, muddy water. Do you see it? So why he is lying to you, saying that the one who believe in such a thing is a liar? Supposedly this is me. When I'm just reading for you what your Quran saying and what your Prophet saying. And now look at this. Are you going now to believe that Muhammad was lying about the interpretation? Muslims, are you going to say Muhammad is a liar? Because this guy, he said it clearly, the one who says so is a liar. All right? Mahdi Bashiri, he wanna call me? I don't know, I'm trying to make the video short for the people to download, but I guess they have to cut it off. We can take one call about this. Mr. Mahdi, he wanna call me? And please don't change the topic because we want to make this video just about this topic. In Skype. Okay, Mr. Mahdi, send me a text, please. I will call you. Mahdi, okay, I see you.
Hello?
Yes, my friend, you are live on air, Mr. Mahdi. What do you want to say to us?
Salam, brother. Can we talk about another topic?
What about this topic? Can you help me first?
Well, I actually called you a couple months ago, and we were like already discussing on this topic.
Yeah, so what
so my response is going to be the same, you know?
What was your response at that time? Remind me.
I basically said that the hadith contradict the Quran on the type of water the sun set and the place where it sets, and
how the Quran contradict the hadith. I don't see that. The Quran is in total agreement because the Quran, my friend, it says, let us read together. The Quran says the sun set in murky water. So how the Quran contradict the hadith? Go ahead.
Because the hadith says that the sun goes underneath the throne of Allah when the throne of Allah is above the seven heavens.
No, and you see, that earth. Okay, my friend. Okay, let me help you. No problem. You see, because you don't have too much knowledge, then you thought this is a mistake. The fact your Prophet, he said that the throne of Allah over the water. Here we go. Let me show you.
Yeah, I know, but like...
No. What do you mean, yeah? You see, you just said the throne of Allah is not above the water, right? So how it's not above the water and your Prophet Muhammad saying that the throne of Allah is above the water? So as you see, Arshahu ala al-ma, Arshahu ala al-ma. Let me put it in the screen. So obviously there's no contradiction. There's no contradiction, my friend. Why you are making a contradiction when it's not? Go ahead.
Can I explain?
Okay, go ahead. Okay, go ahead.
Well, the Quran says that if chapter 18, verse 86 is literal, then it says it sets on earth, and earth in Islam is in the lowest heaven, whereas the throne of Allah is above the seven heavens. So,
okay, my friend,
the Quran says,
I need your help. Can you show me where it says in anywhere, any book, that the earth is in the lower heaven?
I mean, the Quran says that Allah made the stars in the lowest heaven.
Yeah, but the earth is not. But the earth is not a star. And so, simply, the Quran nowhere says that the earth
is
part. the earth is not part of the seven heaven, because the Quran, if you go to chapter 2, it says Allah, he finished everything in earth, and then after that he went to the sky, correct? So Allah, he mentioned the earth as earth and the sky as a sky. So how you made in a magical way, according to you, the earth is part of the seven heaven? He paused. I don't know why. Are you there, my friend? Are you there?
Yeah.
Okay. In chapter two, chapter two, verse twenty-nine. It says, "It is He who created for you all that on earth. Then He went to the sky and He made them seven."
Yeah.
So as you see, the earth is not part of the seven heaven. This is Quran too.
But. Yeah, but like it's just a metaphor for Allah creating.
My friend, hold on, no. So the earth is metaphor, and the sky now is a metaphor, and the water is metaphor, and the ocean is metaphor. So are you going to make everything metaphor? It says He created the earth. How in the world you say to me He created the earth is metaphor?
No, it's not metaphor.
Okay, so He created the earth, and then He went to the sky, and He made them seven. So obviously, the earth is not the sky. Have nothing to do with it.
I know, but the earth is in the lowest heaven.
No, it's not. Show me a proof. Okay, I'm listening. Here we go. You know, you are the one who knows. Okay. I do not know. I will learn from you. Give me a verse that says that earth is part of the lowest heaven. Go ahead.
Okay. The Quran says that we made the stars in the lowest heaven. Am I correct?
Yes.
Okay, and the earth is below the stars.
Hmm. No, it's not below.
So that means,
it's not below.
What do you mean?
Yeah, because the earth is a little tiny ball. Space in the space, so we are not below anything.
No, but this is not my question.
You see, you are the one is making fun of your Quran right now, because my friend, if you say that the earth is below the stars, that is a very, with my respect to you, very ignorant answer, because there is a stars around us. So what is below and what is above?
Well, we're in the same area of the stars. We're in the lowest.
Okay,
seven.
But
the stars
no,
are in the lowest
no,
seven.
No, you see. Here we go. We go, you see, the Muslim, they try to make up things. I challenge you in front of everybody to show me one interpretation saying that the earth is part of the stars or part of the lowest heaven. You will not find. Is that your own religion that you have a new Islam now?
I mean, it's logical, because if the stars are in the lowest heaven.
My friend, are you a person go by logic since when? Is it logical that there is a God who will give you endless private part? Is it logical He will give you endless rivers? Is it logical each time you sleep with them they will be virgin? Is it logical that Jesus, He have a mother, and His mother, she never have a man, and yet she gave birth to a child who is not from a father? Don't talk about logic. Listen. Isn't it the Quran? In chapter 21, verse 30. Hold on. In the Quran, it says that Allah separate the heaven from the earth. Chapter 21, right. Verse number 30. They are totally separated. So how you say we are part of it? Are you against the Quran now?
But CP, can we please talk about the divinity of Jesus?
My friend, hold on. I want you to focus with me. We will go there, no problem, because we have a topic.
Okay.
We want people to download this video and see the answer of the Muslims. And you are a living example of the confusion. So now, when Muhammad, he said the earth, the sun set in a murky water, and the Quran says, and he found the sun set in a murky water. Did he find
Muhammad
it?
Never,
what do you mean?
Muhammad never said the sun sets in a murky water. He said boiling water, which is contradicting to Quran when it says
My friend, the same word, hamia. You see it? Hamia, the same word.
Hamia and hamia is not the same word.
Hamia and hamia is the same word. You can open dictionary and you can read right now.
Well, let's go to the dictionary then.
No problem. Here we go.
Okay. Copy paste the word in the Quran and about hamia and paste it in Google.
Sure. Okay.
Dictionary.
No, Google will not get the translation, because the translation will not know what the word means. But however,
okay, but
we will use dictionary.
No problem.
Okay, dictionary. Oh, give me a second. Let us open dictionary website. Okay, we will pause the dictionary here. There we go. Give me a second.
Are you there?
Yeah, give me a second, my friend. I'm just opening the dictionary. All right. Here we go. This is your dictionary.
Let me see.
Hamia, Kalimat al-Quran. You want me to show it to you in Arabic? I will show it to you in Arabic.
The screen is actually loading. I have to wait for the screen.
Yeah, we can make it Arabic, Arabic, if you want.
Well,
you speak Arabic?
Before the screen shows up, do you speak Arabic?
Do you speak
Arabic? Yes, I speak Arabic, alhamdulillah.
Okay.
But a guy, he went to Ibn Abbas once and he said, how should you recite chapter 18, verse 86? Hamia as boiling water or Hamia as muddy water? And Ibn Abbas responded by muddy water. So actually there's a difference, you know?
Well, my friend, Hamia, you know, obviously, you Muslims are very confused.
I mean,
okay, hold on, hold on. Okay, hold on. So hold on. So you just said that the correct translation is Hamia or Hamia. I mean, the correct reading.
It's muddy water is the correct one.
Which what is the word muddy water in Arabic?
Muddy water is Hamia.
Hamia?
Yes.
Okay, this is, here we go. This is your this is your Islamic translation. I mean, dictionary.
CP, it says
Hima al ain شديد الإصابة بها من حمئة صفة مشابهة etc. It says البئر أخرج طين سوداء المنتن very ugly, disgusting, bad smell, mud. And then he says حما يحمو إحمو فهو حام حمت الشمس أو النار اشتد حرها. So it's both. It is muddy water and it's hot and boiling, as you see. Hamad.
Well, CP, if you use logic, when the Quran is describing earth as muddy water, it's logical because there's no such thing as hot water on earth. But when you go
there is, because we have a spring of hot, muddy water. When the water comes, I can go right now. We can show it to you in video right now. We have a big park in USA for a volcano where the water is coming and the water coming from the ground. It's boiling and it's muddy. This is what happened when it's a volcano. It's muddy.
So why did the guy went to Ibn Abbas and he said, how should he recite it, as muddy water or boiling water?
Because you forgot that your prophet, he told you have 7 readings of the Quran. And actually some scholars, they say there's more than 900 readings for the Quran.
Well, but the meaning stays the same.
Okay, no problem now. But your prophet, my friend, let us say it is hot water or it is not hot water, according to your understanding. Still, the both of them, they say the sun sitting in the water, and both of them, they mean that it's muddy. So thank you very much. So why Allah, he said the sun, he found the sun sitting in muddy water?
Because he was describing his view.
Okay, where it says he was describing his view? Can you show me in the verse where it says that?
No, it doesn't say that.
Okay, so that mean this is your view, not Allah view? Because are you saying that Allah was short in language? He did not know how to explain himself. Isn't it the Quran says وَفَصَّلْنَاهُ تَفْصِيلًا, we made it so clear with details. So how the Quran, which is made clear in details, make you confused, and now you are making your own assumption in order to avoid what the Quran is saying? So nowhere in the Quran it says what you say. The Quran says it clearly, until he found the sitting place of the sun. حَتَّى بَلَغَ مَغْرِبَ الشَّمْسِ وَجَدَهَا تَغْرِبُ فِي عَيْنِ حَمِيَةٍ. So he تَغْرِبُ فِي عَيْنِ حَمِيَةٍ. He found it sitting in a muddy water or hot water. Now, when Allah, he said that, can't he say he thought? He can, right? He thought.
Yeah, but
okay. But he did not say he thought.
Allah.
My friend.
Yes.
Isn't it in verse number 83? Allah, the Jews are asking Muhammad about Zulqarnain. Right?
Yes.
So he said to him, I will tell you about him, correct?
Yes.
Okay. So when Allah, he decided to tell him Zulqarnain about Muhammad about Zulqarnain, is he reporting for him thought or what happened?
He's just reporting his story.
His story. And when he say he found it, when you say he found it, you speak Arabic like me. So if I say, with my respect to you, what's your name, my friend?
Mahdi.
So if I say to you, Mahdi, he went to Iraq and he found in Baghdad the market was closed in Sunday. Is this finding is an opinion of mine or what you found?
But you know the word found in Arabic, it can actually mean two things. It can mean from someone's view, and it can mean literal.
My friend, yes, but the sentence can define for us what he's talking about. If it is something physical, it's physical. So I can say I found my my dream. My dream is a dream, you know, right? My dream girl. I found my destination. This is metaphorical. This is true. But when you say the same as in English, the same we use for the word find in English, I found my love. It doesn't mean you found a physical thing. But here he's speaking about he found it. It, what? The sun. And the sun is something physical. This is not about love. So we cannot play with the word and say this is metaphorical, for he is reporting.
It can still mean his view.
Can you show me? Okay, my friend, in order to say it still its mean, you see, the problem is I just showed you a hadith, and then you say that to me the hadith, what we would do with this hadith now? Your prophet, he have a tongue too?
Okay, but let's get back to the topic about the earth being in the lowest heaven.
Where do you get this from? I asked you where you get this from. You could not.
Because listen, if Muhammad was fabricating things and he did look up the sky, then he saw that the stars were above him. So he thought that the stars are in the lowest heaven, which he said in the Quran. So that means that the earth is in the lowest heaven.
No, hold on. No. Let us see.
And the hadith say.
Okay. Sorry? Okay. What hadith says? Go ahead.
The hadith say that the sun goes underneath the throne of Allah, and the throne of Allah is above the seven heavens.
All right, my friend. Do you agree with that hadith?
No, it's a fabrication because it's a contradiction to
Quran. Oh, so why you are quoting me something you don't agree with? I mean, so anything that Muhammad he say, the Muslim they say it's fabrication because it's obviously exposing Muhammad that he is a fraud. So what we would do now? So your word, my friend, Mahdi. So if you're a prophet saying something, you're Muslim now, you deny what he say because it's embarrassing. So can you give me a hadith which you approve about where the sun set? Just
okay,
one.
You know what? Okay. Let's say sahih. Muhammad is lie. In a hadith, it say Muhammad split the moon, and the chain of narration is sahih. Now, what are you gonna respond?
No. Okay. Hold on. The hadith says that Muhammad split the moon.
Muhammad threw sand at his enemies, and they were blinded. The hadith say Muhammad said to Umar, "Before your death, you will drink
my
milk."
My friend.
The hadith, I believe. Say a lot of miraculous stuff about Muhammad. So why don't you believe in this?
Okay, let me tell you what I always say. I always say whatever Muhammad is saying, obviously he's a liar. So Quran or hadith, is for me, are books of lies. You are talking to Christian prince, my friend. I'm not a Muslim. You are the Muslim, not me. So now I'm asking you, can you give me a hadith you accept, which describe how the sun set? There's only one from all what Muhammad said about the sun setting. You accept, or all Muhammad's statement you rejected because it's embarrassing.
But your personal belief, do you believe that Muhammad said that the sun sets in hot water?
You Muslim telling me he said that, and you see, I'm debating Muslims. I'm not debating myself. I don't believe I don't believe in anything Muhammad he say. I don't know. Maybe my friend, you Muslim, you make a book. Okay, you Muslim, you make a book. And you say the prophet said, and then you're asking me, do you really believe the prophet said that? So if he did not, why you are saying he did?
because your personal beliefs is that you believe that Muhammad was a liar and he said that the sun sets in a
my friend,
water.
Yeah, we can prove it easy. Okay, you know what? I'm going to use I will take advantage of having you. You speak Arabic very well, correct? Okay, according to the Quran, where the hail is coming from?
My friend, this is a metaphor.
What metaphorical? Anything I will say to you, it's metaphorical? Okay, hold on.
No, but okay, wait. It's actually explained in a verse, because the verse says that Allah, he will gather the clouds and he will stack them up. This is like in a form of mountains. It's just a metaphor.
Okay, no. It's why you are saying metaphor? If there's no metaphorical, why you are adding words? Sorry? Okay, anywhere in the Quran, it says this is metaphor or this is your own fiction.
I mean, I go by what the verse says. The verse says Allah gathers the clouds, stacks them up, and then he sends hail from the mountains. This is just a metaphor for clouds.
Okay, my friend, here we go. Show me how we can reach the opinion that this is metaphorical. It says, don't you see how Allah, he put the cloud together, and then he says, وَيُنِزِلُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مِنْ جِبَالٍ فِيهَا مِنْ بَرَدٍ. Okay, translate to everybody. I'm listening.
Okay, he says he sends from hell from mountains in the heaven. So
okay,
what's your point?
So why you are saying it's a metaphor? He sent hell. Guys, hold on, hold on. You are the one who said that. Thank you very much, and laugh at your prophet as much as you wish. Guys, did he just say, so Allah, he sent from the sky, from mountains in it, hail. How that can be metaphor? There's mountains in the sky, and Allah, he sent hail from it. Explain to us how this has became metaphor. Is the rain metaphorical? No. Is the hail metaphorical? No. Where the hail is coming from? From mountains in the sky. How in the world you come to the conclusion that this metaphorical? I will tell you how. Because the only way for you to escape the reality that Muhammad is fabricating stuff is to say this metaphorical. I like it when a Muslim, he laughs at his prophet. Go ahead.
Because right before it, it says Allah gathers the clouds and stacks them up.
Okay.
This is in the form of mountains.
Okay.
It's just a metaphor.
Where? No. It's where it says the form of mountain. Here we go. I want to see it. Here we go. Where it says, no, hold on. You see. I want to show everybody. Stop laughing like a girl, please. Either you are a man or you are a kid. So where it says he make it like mountain. Can you show me the word? Where it says he make it like mountains.
It's logical to say if God gathers.
My friend, don't say things. Hold on. You just lied about your Quran saying it says that Allah, he gathered the cloud like mountain. Can you show me the word mountain there in the verse? I'm listening.
Okay, it says he gathers the clouds and stacks them up.
Okay.
This is just the interpretation is that they become in the form of mountains.
Where it says the word form of mountain, can you show it to me? I'm just asking you, does it say that Allah, he made them like mountains? It doesn't say that. So you are fabricating now your own Quran in order to solve the problem. So it says, don't you see that how Allah, he gathered the cloud and then he make it in the top of each other? And then he, and then the rain come from it, and then he continue and he add to it, and وَيُنْزِلُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ, this is additional sentence, وَيُنْزِلُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ, and he send it from the sky, not from the even the cloud, from the sky, from mountains in it, hail. Does it say that online?
Let me ask you something. Do you believe that the Quran meant is literal?
Well, this is about the rain, how the rain and the hail is coming. This is not metaphorical.
I mean, if the Bible was saying this, then I wouldn't believe that the Bible was meaning this.
My friend. If we go and try to read how this is happening, how what the Muslims believe, they will agree that Allah is telling us how Allah created things and how things happen. It's not metaphorical. So why we are fabricating things, making it metaphorical? Because simply it's embarrassing. It's proving to us that Muhammad is not a prophet and the Quran cannot be from God. As simple as that.
Okay, but can we talk about the heaven and earth contradiction in chapter 41, verse 9 to 12, that contradiction?
Okay, can we finish first before, and I have all the time for you, I will stay with you until tomorrow. Okay, so let us finish here. So when Allah, he said the sun set in murky water, he was speaking about the story of Alexander the Great. And then he said he found next to it, next to what? Can you explain to me?
People.
He found next to the sitting place of the sun, people, correct?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
But look here, how the Quran exposed Muhammad even more harshly, because he found next to where the sun set people, but sun set everywhere.
But this is just from his view, where the sun set, and then next to it were people.
Correct, but he found it. He keep walking, and then he found the sun sitting place, and he found next to it people. Correct.
But doesn't the verses after say that he traveled again and he found the sun rising?
Thank you very much. So here the Quran is telling us about two places, and I'm very thankful for you are mentioning this. So he traveled again. Hold on, my friend. Hold on. Alexander the Great, how many years his trip was? Many years. The guy did not even go back to his country. He died in the war zone. So this is not about one day trip. This is about many years of trip. So are you saying to me that this guy, he found the sun setting only in once and the sun rising once? No.
I mean, for sure not.
But the Quran
is proof of a metaphor.
Yeah, no, it's not metaphorical. Read carefully, because you are the one who
said for his view.
Hold on. Nowhere it says his view, because the one is talking is Allah. So how this can be view?
Okay,
my
can
friend.
Can you show me the Quran? Wait, CP, please let me. Can you show me the Quran where Allah says the sun sets in murky water without narrating someone's story?
It says in front of us. Here we go. until he reached
without narrating someone's story, like Allah himself saying the Quran says the sun sets in the murky water.
Okay, my friend, but when Allah he says when he reached the sitting place of the sun, Allah saying he reached.
Oh my God.
So who is the one who's talking? Allah. Okay, he's narrating
okay,
what
he but he's narrating his story.
Okay, no problem. So if I tell you now that Mahdi he went to Iraq, is that metaphorical trip or this is a real trip? It's a trip. It's a real and Mahdi is real. Okay. He found in Iraq a Sistani, the Shia controlling the country. Is that a fake found or a true found? It's a true found. Because I'm saying to you, he found. When you say the word found in Arabic or in English, it's mean you are reporting a fact. You don't say he found unless
well,
it is
that
a find.
That word in Arabic can mean two things, his perspective or literal.
My friend, this is true if you are talking about something spiritual, maybe, or let us say like love or etc. But here we are talking about a physical object, so it's going to be always literal. Because we are talking about the sun. We are not talking about love or emotion, or those are not physical. So here we are talking about a physical object. It's called the sun, and the sun is sitting in the muddy, murky water. So if let us say for the sake of argument, Alexander the Great, he found the sun sitting in murky water. Why Allah, he says, he found it sitting in murky water? I mean, this is stupid, because I am saying to you, I'm agreeing with it, because if I say he found, I am not telling you what only what he found. I'm agreeing with him. He found it, and I am the one who's telling you what you do not know. Allah is telling Muhammad in verse number 83, the Jews ask him, tell us about Zulqarnain. He said, okay, Allah told me to tell you the following. So Allah is saying, Zulqarnain he found. Okay, and if he did not find that, why Allah he say he found?
Maybe it's just from his perspective.
My friend, how I can say, you see, I should say, let us say Zulqarnain, Zulqarnain is already dead when Muhammad is talking, correct? So what's the point to say he found it sitting in murky water unless I agree with him?
I mean, it's like saying he found it setting and later he found it rising.
Okay, so he found the sun rise. Okay, well, but the sun rise everywhere. Look, my friend,
but,
you are the one who mentioned this. Look at this. And then it says, and then he changed, he followed another way until he came to the rising place of the sun. But the rising place of the sun is everywhere. So what the story acknowledged two things, that there's a place where the sun rises from and there is a place where the sun set in. And this guy, he continued his journey until he reached those places, which means this is the end of the world. That's it. There's no more to go. The rising place of the sun and the setting place of the sun. But this is a horrible mistake because the sun rise and set everywhere. But Muhammad, he claimed, not the appearance of the sun where it's a rise for us. There's a sitting place for the sun physically, and there's a rising place for the sun physically. And then here again, he repeat the same mistake. And he found it rising on people who Allah provide no shelter for them. So he found the sun rising where? In a place. And what he found? People next to it. And he found it rising on those people. And then here, your Zulqarnain, he built a dam between us, the human, and Gog and Magog. How you can solve this problem now?
I mean, I gave my responses. If people don't like the responses, then they can believe.
No, my friend, no problem.
Want.
You respond.
Yeah.
I'm trying to get your response too. Okay, the dam he built, is that metaphorical or real? He found, he keep going, keep going, keep going. And he found where the sun rise. Okay, so now if me and you, we take our car or our donkeys and we keep going until we found where the sun rise, we will find where the dam of Gog and Magog.
Okay, but if that's literal, that but the sun going in the murky water, then the verse after say it rises, then that means the sun was in the ground and it traveled all the way through the rising place, which
exactly.
is, I don't believe it's literal.
Exactly,
sorry.
Because this is what your prophet said.
My prophet didn't believe that. He believed, like every other Arab, that the sun was bigger than the ground.
No, hold on. No, that's not true.
There's no way.
Okay, hold on. Okay. Let's see what your prophet said, because you are saying things not true. Here we go. Is that your prophet talking? And this is Sahih. He said to him, where the sun set, he said to him, goes under the throne of Allah. And this is interpretation for chapter 36, verse number 38.
But this is contradicting to the Quran.
My friend, it's not, because Quran, he is quoting for you the Quran. Your prophet quoting for you the Quran, chapter 36, verse number 38. And this is the interpretation of a chapter 36.
But that proves that the guy who fabricated this hadith, he didn't know what he was talking about.
Okay.
Because the hadith, the throne of Allah is above the seven heavens. The Quran says the earth, it sits on earth when it's in the lowest heaven. How can it be?
Okay, hold on. Where you learn that the throne of Allah is above the seven heaven?
The hadith.
But you deny the
and
hadith.
And the Quran.
No. A second ago you said you denied the hadith. Now you are saying you accept the hadith, correct?
I denied this hadith.
Ah, so you choose as you wish. Okay. Can you give me the hadith? Okay, I will go with you. Can you give me the hadith which says about your Allah above the throne? Is it the one that says that Allah in the top of the eight mountain goats?
I mean, doesn't Allah say that He established Himself above the throne?
No problem. But is that the hadith you are talking about? It says that Allah throne is about in the top of eight mountain goats.
The angels, they will carry this throne.
Okay, so is that a physical throne carried by eight goats?
I don't know anything about Allah or His nature or His throne. All right. I can't respond.
Okay, so the hadith confirm again that nothing on that is metaphorical. Here we go, you just said eight angels, they are carrying the throne of Allah. So the throne of Allah is real and the goats are carrying Allah is real. And Allah is in the top of the throne.
Sorry, the goat's carrying Allah?
Yeah, because those are eight angels, but they have a look of a goat.
Yeah, but they carry His throne, not Allah Himself.
No problem, but if Allah is in the top of the throne, they are carrying Allah.
No, but He's above it. He's not like sitting on the throne right now.
It says, how you can say He is not sitting if He is in the top of the throne? So what He's doing, standing?
Let me explain that. A hadith say that after the angels will carry Allah's throne and they will place it, then Allah will descend in a way on the throne. So He's not actually sitting on it, you know?
Well, how you come to this conclusion? So are you saying to me, guys, hold on. So you are saying to me that the angels are carrying the throne, but the throne is empty.
They are carrying it and they will place it and then Allah will descend on the throne.
Okay, so He is in the top of the throne or not? I'm confused now.
He's above it.
Okay, so
he's not like sitting on it.
He fly in the top of it, he don't sit.
What the hell?
What the hell? Yeah, tell me, what do you mean? What do you mean Allah is descending on the throne? Is He in the top of it? He is what? He's sitting, He's standing, what He's doing there? What do you mean He's in the top of it, but He is not on it?
Okay, but are the angels carrying the throne of Allah right now?
No problem. Allah's throne is carried by eight angels in the look of goats. No problem. Now, those angels, who is in the top of the throne? Who is in the top of the throne?
So wait. Let me ask you this: Do the angels carry the throne of Allah right now, or will they do it on the judgment day?
As I know, they are carrying it all the time.
No, that's not true. Because on the judgment day, Allah will say to the angels, "Carry the throne," and then they will try to carry it, but they cannot do it, and they will say to Allah, "We can't do it." Then Allah will give them the power.
Yeah, because this is Allah. Supposedly, He's trying to do to be like Santa Claus. He want to move like Santa Claus. His bike is heavy, so they try to carry it. So Allah give them a bush. And this is again another stupid story of your prophet. You just said everybody heard you, and this is true what you said. The hadith says that Allah, He ordered the angels to carry His throne, and the angels, they will not be able to carry it because it's so heavy. So Allah, He give them a lift, and then they will be able to carry it. Okay, a question. Why the angels cannot carry the throne of Allah if Allah is not in the top of the throne? Why is it so heavy?
I don't know.
Okay, question. You do not know why it's so heavy, but why? How Allah is saying to the angels, carry the throne, but then the angels cannot carry the throne. Do Allah knew that they cannot?
Yeah, He knew.
Okay, so how He ordered them to carry it if they cannot?
Because that's like how Allah does it. So if you know Allah and His personality, then
So Allah, He says to me, talk, and I am mute, and then I cannot talk. So Allah, He ordered me to talk, but yet I cannot talk. So Allah, what He do then? Allah, He talk Himself, and I don't talk. So what the point of saying to me, talk?
I mean, if you want to look at that way, say by saying what's the point of it, then it's your beliefs. If you want to believe that, then okay.
Okay, my friend, let us go back. You see, you're a prophet here. He says, if you see in the hadith in front of you, that Allah, there is seven skies and there is a sea. In the sky, there is a sea. And Allah's throne is in the top of the sea. Do you see it?
Allah, above that sea is a throne and above that throne is Allah.
So that sea isn't
murky or something.
Yeah, but do you agree with that? That Allah throne above the sea?
Yes.
Okay. Guys, just to show you something. He agree with this hadith, but this hadith is da'if.
Oh, it is?
Yeah. So he agree with the one which usually Muslims reject, and he disagree with the one which usually Muslims accept. So you are like in the opposite direction.
No,
when you want, you make it da'if. When you want, you make it strong. So this is a game the Muslim, they come with always. I don't like it, I say it is da'if. I like it, I say it's strong. So here we go. This is da'if hadith. You accept it. You have no problem with it. Why? Because simply you like it.
If it's da'if, then I don't accept it.
No, a second ago you accept it. So what do you mean? Just by saying to you in a website it says da'if, you refuse it? That is a joke, my friend. A second ago you said you agree with it.
But the Quran says that Allah's throne is above the waters.
Okay, so you agree with it. So how is da'if then? You are the one who tried to teach me saying, if the hadith does not contradict the Quran, according to you, then that is, we should accept. Here we go. And you accept it. The second I showed you, it says da'if, you spit it.
Okay, but if it's da'if, then it's da'if. I don't accept it.
Okay. But what about if I show you a strong hadith? Do you accept it? You will say no.
Okay, no problem. I was about to say that. I was like going to say, isn't there any strong hadith about this hadith? Because I remember.
Okay, let us make it simple, sorry? My friend. Let us make it simple. You know, me and you, we are playing the game. Any hadith Christian prince, he will show me. Prove that Muhammad is a liar, I will say I don't accept
okay.
it. And any
okay,
hadith but, Christian prince,
okay,
he show me.
Now let me ask you the same. The hadith where it says that Muhammad split the moon, do you accept that hadith?
Okay, hold on. Muhammad, he split the moon, but the moon did not split.
Yes.
So obviously the Quran and the hadith both are a lie. Because here we go, let us go. You are the one who mentioned
okay.
it, so you have to handle it now. If you go to the chapter of the moon, it says that is sa'a wa shaqqa al-qamar. Okay, the moon, the time, the judgment day is a sight, and the moon split. Okay, did the moon really did the moon split according to science? Where? Okay, can you prove it to me where we can find the moon splitting? The moon is there because when you say,
what do you mean?
Okay, when you say the moon is split, that's mean the moon is split.
Yes.
It's two pieces. Is the moon now two pieces?
Yeah, but he brought it back together after they denied.
Okay, hold on. Where it says that Allah, he put it together.
But what's the point of splitting the moon? Is to show the pagans a miracle.
My
and
friend,
then if
okay.
they deny it, then you put it back together.
There's a guy, his name is Fifi. He said that Allah split the moon for a few seconds only. And at that time, nobody saw it. He said that because it was a very few. Nobody reported this because it was very few seconds. So what's the point of this garbage? So it says here, اقتربت الساعة, and the moon split. You're a prophet saying that Allah told him that judgment day is in the corner. You know what in Arabic it says, اقتربت. اقتربت is not only near, it's in the corner. So, اقتربت الساعة وانشق القمر. The judgment day is almost there and the moon split. So, this is a sign of a judgment day. Okay, did Allah stop his judgment day time or what happened? Because the moon splitting is a sign from the judgment day. But judgment day did not happen in the last 1400 years yet. So how the moon splitting is a part of the judgment day as a sign, and yet nothing happened?
Now, can I explain?
Sure. Hold on. Somebody saying if you want to debate Farid, give your
wait,
start
wait, wait.
Here.
See,
hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on.
Give
hold on.
Me 1 minute.
Okay.
Give me one. I need to. I'm gonna be back. Give me 1 minute. I'm gonna mute my mic. Okay.
Okay, no problem. The one who's saying if you want to debate Farid, give me your Skype, I will give it to him. My friend, everybody knows my Skype. How this guy knew my Skype? Debate TV. And the potato, he will never dare because he's a kid. And by the way, I'm not honored to even to speak to such a guy. He's a kid. He's a kid and there is something wrong with him, obviously.
No.
So, you know, don't mention those names for me. Okay, go ahead, my friend, Maddie. So, the judgment day is near and the moon is split. And this is mentioned in the Quran. Okay, but there's no moon split and there's no evidence of that. Okay, so the Muslim, they lie. Thank you for agreeing that the Muslim, they lie by posting those pictures. So now why?
Why
Allah split the moon, my friend?
They like to loot it.
Mahdi, the moon is split for what purpose?
To show the pagans that Muhammad is a prophet.
Okay. And supposedly,
my friend,
yeah? Did the pagans really see that the moon is split?
I mean, can I first respond to what you said before?
Go ahead.
Okay, first of all, the Quran says that Allah said to Musa more than 1,000 years before Muhammad that the hour is near. So when Allah says, Prophet in Quran, chapter 75. For them the hour is near, for them the hour is far, but for us it is near. So that's what the Quran actually meant. It can mean 1,000 years before.
No problem. I agree with you. I agree with you. That is can. I agree with you. That is possible. But look here, you missed something, Mr. Mahdi. That here it says the hour judgment is night and the moon split ascender. So the judgment day started because the moon split. This is not an event will happen every day.
Okay, can I explain?
Go ahead.
It doesn't say that the moon is a sign, the moon split is a sign for the hour. It just says the hour is near and the moon has split. That's two different things. And in the Bible, in the New Testament, Jesus said the time is near and I will be coming soon.
Okay, but the time, okay, my friend, the time is near. The time is near is a warning for everybody. And I agree with you. A second ago, I said it can be that you're speaking about warning for the time to come. But here, the judgment day already started because the moon split.
No.
And why Allah, he put the moon? Okay, nowhere in the Quran says Allah, he split the moon and then Allah, because, listen, if the moon is split and Allah put the moon together, that is two miracles, not one. Can you show me the verse where it says, I split the moon and then I put it together?
It's in the Quran when you use logical sense, because
where?
The point of... Because we need the moon. We need the moon for light. That's what the Quran says. The point of showing the pagans a miracle is to prove that Muhammad was a true prophet. But if they deny it, then there's no point in showing the miracle.
Okay, I want to go with you. I want to go with you. I learned from you, if something contradicting the Quran, we should reject. Do you accept?
Yep.
Okay. If we go here, and I will do it in the front of your eyes. It says, مَا مَنَعَنَا. Nothing made us refrain from sending miracles, chapter 17, verse number 59, except that former generation, they refused them. Okay.
Uh-huh.
Was Allah refraining from making miracle to Muhammad, or he was not refraining?
Well, the pagans asked for a miracle, and Muhammad Allah kept responding by saying, no, why should I do that when the generations before you guys rejected, but they kept asking Muhammad for a miracle until Allah showed them the splitting of the moon, but they still denied. I mean, it doesn't mean it contradict the Quran.
No, but we will see, because here we go, the Quran saying Allah he refrained. So if we say that Quran saying Allah he refrained, obviously Allah he refrained. You know what refrain mean, right? So we refrain from sending Quran, all right, because former generation treated as false.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so as long Allah he say clearly that he refrained from sending Quran, that means he did not send Quran. He did not send a miracle. He refrained from sending a miracle.
But the pagans, they kept asking him. So Allah, even though he knew they would deny, he showed them this miracle. It doesn't mean it didn't happen.
Okay, but when you say I refrained from sending, it's mean I refrained from sending. Okay, Quran.
Wasn't that before Allah showed them the splitting of the moon?
Oh, that's a good question. Okay, let me ask you. According to the book of Revelation, which means the Quran, according to Revelation, all right? Was it the moon chapter revealed before or the chapter of Al-Isra?
According to what revelation?
The order of revelation. You know that the Muslim, they changed the Quran, how it is.
I believe that. Today, Uthman, he put it in the correct order, because first we have the stories of the prophets and the laws, and then we have Allah using poetry, and then at the end we have these small prayers, you know. So yeah, it's not like because in the beginning when Muhammad he put them, it was all mixed up. The Surah Al-Fatiha, the opening, it wasn't even chapter one, and it was all mixed up. So Uthman did a good job on putting the Quran in order.
Okay, you know, I'm going to do something, and I will wait for you on the screen. Give me a second, please, and let us do this. Because in order to understand things, we have to make it more clear, and we will make it clear in a second. All right. So now we have it. Okay, and now we go to 17. Oh. I will put in the front of everybody. What do you see in the screen, my friend? Tell me.
Let me see. It's coming up. Just wait.
Okay.
I see it.
Okay, what is the real number of the Quran verse, the chapter?
37.
So now in the Quran today, the verse is numbered as 54, but in the real Quran is number 37. Okay, now let us see.
No, but like, did Muhammad say Surah Al-Qamah is the 37th surah, or is it just revealed?
You see, hold on. You see, this is not the question. The question is, according to revelation, the order we see now, according to revelation, which one first, which one after? So look what happened. In chapter, the Al-Qamar, chapter Al-Qamar is revealed as number 37, as you see. But a chapter of Al-Isra is number 50.
Uh-huh.
So after Allah, he made the miracle of the moon split, he says, we refrain from sending miracles. But already he did. So obviously, either this story is a fabrication added to the Quran, or if you are a person, if you are a person who is honest, you should say, you are the one who taught me. If we find contradiction with the Quran, we refuse. Correct?
Yeah, but like, this is not a contradiction.
This is a contradiction because Allah, he said he did not do any miracle. He refrained. And
no. It doesn't say he didn't do any miracle. It says we will not send a miracle to the pagans.
Yes, but you are the one who just said to me a second ago that Allah, he split the moon to show the pagan that Muhammad is a prophet.
Okay.
So how he will not send miracles and he said that after he did the miracle of the moon splitting? Because that will be stupid. Already you did one.
Okay, I see where you're going, but like, still, it doesn't refute what the Quran says.
No, it does refute. If I say to you, I will never. Okay, let us say you are coming. I own a restaurant, and I give you a dish, and you start eating, and now your stomach is full, and you say to me, I will never make a dish for you. What? I already ate the dish. So what do you mean here? So when you have to give things in order. If Allah is saying I will never give a miracle, and then already he gave, that means there's a fabrication here. Somebody is lying.
I mean, if that's your understanding of fabrication, then you have
to. No. This is your understanding. You see, you are biting your tongue now. You are the one who said to me, if a hadith contradict the Quran, we don't accept the hadith, correct?
But the moon spitting, Muhammad spitting, the moon is in the Quran as well.
No, the Quran nowhere it says, okay, you know what, I will shave my 20-foot beard if you show me where in the Quran it says Muhammad spit the moon. Go ahead.
Oh, okay. Go to verse 6 of Surah Al-Qamar.
Verse 6? Okay, here we go. Verse 6, yes. Chapter of Al-Qamar. Okay, go ahead. Let me go
there. It says, before that, Allah said, the hours come near the moon has split, and the pagans rejected this miracle.
Okay,
and
where says in verse 6. Hold on, where it says that Muhammad, he split the moon. You remember what I said? I said, I will shave my 20 foot beard if you can show me what it says. No, don't explain. Why Muslims need to explain something is there? I mean, if it's there, show me the verse. So you are making your own explanation now.
Okay, let me talk.
You are making it. Why you need explanation if the Quran is saying so? Can you show me the verse? It says that Muhammad, he split the moon.
Verse 6. It says,
where it says that?
The prophet,
okay, here we go.
Oh my God.
Where it says, Allah, he said to the prophet. What does that mean? Here we go. Where it says the moon is split by Muhammad? Show me the verse.
Okay. Before it, Allah spoke about the pagans rejecting this miracle. And then it says in verse 6, Allah says to the one who performed the miracle, so leave them.
What? Where it says the one who performed the miracle? Where it says that?
So what is the point? No.
You speak Arabic. Hold on. I want you to read for me. You speak Arabic very well and translate the verse. Verse number 6. I'm listening.
It says there, so leave, Allah says to the one who performed the miracle.
Where is the word performed the miracle? If we take this text in Google translation and we translate, we will find the word, the one who performed the miracle.
No. Listen. It says, so leave them.
Okay. So now how the Quran saying leave them became the one who performed the miracle? It's a miracle.
Because Muslims
change the meaning. The verse, guys, the verse he just admitted, the verse always says, leave them because they don't accept you. That is where it says,
exactly.
Muhammad, he did the miracle. Where it says the miracle? Where it says Muhammad, he did the miracle? Nowhere.
Because it is logical. So why would Allah say to the prophet, so leave them, when he didn't perform the miracle?
Because they don't believe in him anyway. He's a liar. And I'm asking you, where in the Quran, you see, even in the verse which is saying that, nowhere it says even Allah, he did that. It says the hour is near and the judgment day, the moon is split. So Allah is not even saying, I did that. Okay, hold on. So this was the eclipse. And obviously, Muhammad, he used to go crazy when the eclipse happened. Yes. Let me ask you about hashish then. What the word eclipse in Arabic? What is the word eclipse? What is the word eclipse in Arabic? Mahdi, what is the word eclipse?
Wait.
What the word eclipse in Arabic?
The moon split is literally different.
What do you mean?
Yeah, your mic's cutting a little bit. The moon split is literally different than an eclipse.
Okay.
An eclipse is just the moon going in front of the sun, and that's
okay.
Hold on. Split the moon.
But okay, a second ago, guys, look at the madness of the Muhammadan when they try to explain the Quran. When we speak about Zulqarnain, he found the sun sitting in murky water. They say he thought. But now, Muhammad, he did not thought this is the moon splitting. It is an eclipse. Let us prove it. Here we go. When the eclipse happened, your prophet, he go crazy. Is that true?
So how could Muhammad know that an eclipse, eclipse happened?
Okay.
How could Muhammad know that? Because the pagans wanted the miracle.
Okay, hold on. You're a prophet. Okay. You're a prophet. He think this is a sign from the judgment. Each time the time the eclipse happened, this is the moon splitting. Read with me. We were ordered to free a slave at the time of the lunar eclipse. Do you see it?
I'm not looking at your screen.
Okay.
Right now, but,
this is Sahih al-Bukhari. You're a prophet going crazy and he stopped praying like crazy each time the eclipse happened. Read carefully. It says, reported from Ibn Abbas, blah, 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 the Messenger of Allah observed 4 rak'at and 4 prostration in 2 rak'at. Let us see more. What happened when the eclipse happened? Muhammad, you go not. Muhammad, he mentioned even that the eclipse is a sign from the judgment day. This is the hadith of Sahih Muslim. And this is the hadith number. And this is the reference, 2901. So the sun eclipse is one of the sign of the judgment day. This is the moon splitting. And now, hold on. You see, because we need to show more. We need to show more. Madness of Muhammad. All right.
Your mic's cutting a little bit.
No problem. Here we go. Let us see. Look how many hadith they are talking about the judgment day sign as one of them is the eclipse.
My friend, I can easily refute this.
Okay, refute.
You realize that, right?
Okay, go ahead. Go ahead, refute. Go ahead. Why the eclipse is the sign of a judgment day and Muhammad go crazy?
When the pagans ask Muhammad for a miracle and Muhammad said, I'm going to split the moon, how could they know that, how could Muhammad know that an eclipse will happen now?
How he knew? Where it says that?
How he knew that the eclipse will happen now?
Where it says? It says in the Quran that judgment day is near and the moon is split. It's already split.
Yeah, but the hadith say that when Muhammad split the moon, one side of the moon went to the other side of the mountain and one went to the other side of the mountain.
Okay, so that means the moon went really far from each other, right? Because when you say one side of the mountain and the other side of the mountain, that will be translated to millions of kilometers, correct?
And by the way, when it says...
Don't say by the way. You said, you just said, everybody heard you, that the moon is split and one side to the other side of the mountain and one went to the other side of the mountain. What mountain? We are talking about a moon, very huge. And if the moon is split for a second, the earth will face a biggest disaster. Why? Because one of the side of the moon will hit the earth. The earth will grab at least one side of the moon toward it and is going to destroy the earth. Secondly, we will have a lot of storms. My friend, no historian.
That's why it's called a miracle. A miracle doesn't go by science.
By sight, what nobody saw it. Okay, why no historian?
No, miracle they ask, go by science.
They ask a Muslim, why nobody saw, nobody reported, not the Roman, not the Greek, not the Persian, not the Chinese.
So when the Bible says the sun stopped for a moment, why did nobody report that?
Well, it's reported by even their enemies reporting
show
that.
Me, show me.
Okay, well, you're the one who said to me, the Bible said, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so. If we are talking about the Bible saying that the people they've been granted victory and there's no way to explain how a small amount of army can win against a big army except that God will support them. Now hold on. I'm going with your logic, right? No. how you Muslims, you say something is not in the Quran.
Okay, but first of all, before you said that, we Muslims, we have been given victory by Allah over the Christians when we were a small number and the Christians were a big number.
That's false. So that's false. Here we go. The Quran, Muhammad, he predict that 100 they can fight against the kuffar and they will win, and he lost.
Can we?
No.
Can we please talk about it?
No, hold on. You are jumping. Here we go. This is again a false prophecy. If you're a prophet, he told the Muslims, 100 of you, and you are the one who mentioned it, 100 of you can fight against 1,000, correct?
Can we please talk about an important topic?
No problem. You are talking about important. You are the one who mentioned this. How your prophet, he lied to you saying 100 can fight against 1,000 and then the Muslim, they go and they lose.
Can you first show me the reference of where it said the Muslim?
Chapter 8, verse number 65. And Muhammad, he claimed that he saw a dream that the enemy, they are small in number, and the Muslims are bigger than number. And the top of that, he said to them, Allah told me to encourage the Mujahideen to go for war and fight the Kuffar, for 100 of you can be victorious against 1,000. Then the Muslim, they went for the war, and they came back, and they've been spanked badly. So right away, Muhammad, he changed the verse. He says, Allah just informed me in verse number 66 that he found weakness on you. So not 100 can fight 1,000, one can fight two.
Okay.
So
from
100,
from topic. One,
this is an important topic. If Allah, he promised you victory, 100 against 1,000, how Allah, he found the weakness? The weakness we found in Allah, because nothing changed. Those are the same Muslims. My friend,
you don't even answer my question about the Bible's historical evidence for the sun being stopped.
You see, I'm going with your logic. We don't have hadith to contradict and say, this hadith says different story. We Christians, we accept what the Bible says. You Muslims don't accept even what the Quran says. You don't accept even what your prophet said. So if a prophet, he said something, I don't say I don't accept what the prophet said. I say accept what he said. You Muslim, you do the opposite. Your prophet says something, you deny it, and then you choose and you pick up your cherries as you wish. So either you are a believer or you are a picky believer. Are you a picky believer?
No.
Okay, if you are not a picky believer, explain to me how Allah, he says 100 can fight against 1,000 and then they lose.
Why?
And then Allah, he correct himself right away, right after it. They came back, they lost the war. I'm not changing the topic, you see.
Can we now talk about the important topic?
You are the one who changed the topic. You made me jump from place to place, and wherever you go. The second we open a topic, isn't it you a second ago, is the one who says to me, yes, Allah, He grant us when you are small in number, we can fight and win. Where you win? You lose everywhere. You see, the Muslims, when a Muslim, he say they win, the fact they never win anywhere. Even when they took even when they took over Egypt, you are the one who have no answer, my friend.
No, but you really talk too much.
Hold on. I'm going to go to Mehdi. What is your question? I will change all the topics. I will go with your topic. But this time, be honest, you will not change.
Okay, no problem.
Okay, go. What is your question?
Jesus divine in Islam.
Is Jesus divine in Islam? Yes.
Okay, show me the reference.
Here we go. Let us see. I want you to read for me this hadith.
This hadith, okay. What does the hadith say? Your screen is like slowly coming up.
Okay, I want you to translate first in English, in Arabic, what it says. Right. Translate. سبوح قدوس رب الملائكة والروح.
It's just the one bowing and prostrating our glorious and our holy Lord of the angels and the spirits. So,
what the word سبوح, what the word قدوس mean?
So, where does say Jesus?
Okay, we are coming. Here we go.
What
is the word قدوس mean?
Where does say Jesus?
Okay, here we go. You know, we are going step by step.
We have many types of.
Okay. So you will. You will not. Jibreel. Okay. Let me ask you. Other... Who is the spirit of Allah? Who is the spirit of Allah?
Like, what do you mean by spirit? Like when you.
I am asking you. Don't tell me you don't. What do you mean? You don't know what you mean. I'm saying, what is the spirit of Allah? Who is the spirit of Allah?
Allah doesn't have a spirit.
Allah does not have a spirit. Okay.
Yeah, which is part of his body. Allah doesn't have.
Thank you very much. Okay, here we go. Allah, guys, does not have a spirit. So why the Quran saying we send our spirit, ruhana?
Because, like, when you say, for example, Abdullah, a slave of Allah, that doesn't mean the slave is a part of Allah. It just means he's a part of his creation.
Okay, is the spirit of Allah is holy or it's not holy?
Well, first of all, that's actually a good question, because I'll just explain to you what Jesus is in Islam.
Hold on. Before we go, you are the one who asked me the question. Let us follow. You see, I asked you to translate what the word Quddus, you refuse. What the word Quddus mean?
It means holy.
Holy, thank you very much. Guys, did he say holy? All right. So, when the Quran says we send our Holy Spirit, what is holy in Islam? Is that God or anyone else?
I'm going to explain.
Okay,
because when you say holy, it doesn't mean specifically God.
Ah, okay. But there is other holy person beside Allah in Islam. Is that correct?
Well, English is not really my native language.
No, you speak English better than me. Don't make excuse now. Come on, you speak English better than mine. So, the word holy, is it something attached only to Allah, or there's others who they are holy beside Allah?
There's no God except Allah.
This is not the question. Who is holy beside Allah? Is it only Allah, or there is beside him other holy persons?
What do you mean by holy? Do you mean like
you see the pure question, guys? I mean, how? What do you mean? What do you mean by holy? Suddenly, he don't know what holy.
Yeah.
I asked him what Quddus mean. He said holy, and now he do not know what holy. Now I need me to tell you what holy is.
Okay.
You know what holy means, so I'm asking you if there is someone beside Allah is holy.
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
Can I just explain what Jesus is in Islam?
No. Here we go. We are explaining. Here we go. It says that Allah, He says, Ruhul Qudus. Ruhul Qudus. I ask you, what Qudus mean? You said, holy. Okay. Ruh is a spirit. Okay. What is that spirit which is holy?
Sorry?
What is that spirit which is holy?
Where in the Quran does it say that, or in the hadith? The hadith you showed me before, right?
This is da'if hadith.
No. I'll just accept it, no problem. We have... Isa is not only...
This is not the question. Don't change the topic. Don't change the topic. What? When we say the word Quddus or Qudus is holy, and you accept that, and you are the one who gave an answer, thank you. Now, Ar-Ruhul Qudus, the spirit which is holy. How this spirit is holy, and who is that spirit?
Who is that spirit? I have no idea. Maybe it can be Jibril, maybe it can be Isa, I don't know.
Oh, this is let me introduce to you the religion of maybe. Those people, they are following religion of maybe, so you do not know? What? Hold on. I heard you very well. I'm not deaf. You said maybe it is Jibril, maybe it is Isa. Did you say that?
There's other spirits also mentioned in the Quran.
No. There's only one Holy Spirit. Nowhere in the Quran.
No. Don't lie.
Okay, hold on.
The Quran says.
I challenge you, show me. Okay, hold on. I challenge you. No, before you say it, don't say it. Don't surprise me.
Don't lie.
Don't say it first. Please surprise me. Like, hit me in the face. I want you. It's a challenge. If you show me one place in the Quran, mention that there is a spirit is holy beside the Holy Spirit. Go ahead.
Sorry, I don't understand the question.
I said to you, only the Holy Spirit is mentioned in the Quran as Holy Spirit. You said, no, there's other spirit. I challenge you to show me in the Quran where it says there is spirits which are holy named in the Quran. Go ahead.
Doesn't the Quran say, for example, that the spirit and the angels ascend to him or something?
Does it say it's holy? No.
Okay, but I believe that the Holy Spirit is Jibreel.
No problem. Okay, now guys, the Holy Spirit is Jibreel. That means Jibreel is holy.
Okay.
Okay, and God is holy. So Allah and Jibreel, they are both are holy. And that means that Jibreel is perfect. That's because he is the same as God. He don't make mistakes, correct?
No. Like angels, they do not sin. Isa doesn't sin. Let me explain why Isa doesn't sin in Islam. Like every other prophet sins except Isa. Because the Quran says that Jesus is his word and his spirit. Let me explain to you what this means. The Quran says that Allah created Jesus by the word be. The word be is what makes Jesus the word of Allah. And when Allah says to Isa, his spirit, it doesn't mean a spirit which is a part of his body, but a part of his creation. So when Allah said, the reason why Allah says his word and his spirit is because Allah is saying the uniqueness of a human to Isa is that humans were created by two parents consummating with each other and then forming a baby. When Isa wasn't created like that, he was created by the word be. And the reason why Isa is sinless is because his nature is sinless. He's a spirit which is sinless, like angels are. For example, when we humans, our nature is not sinless. So that's why Isa is sinless. It's because he's originally a spirit. The Quran says Jesus is a spirit which Allah cast down on Maryam, and Jibril took that spirit and he blew it into Maryam. Do you understand?
All right. Are you finished?
Yeah.
Okay, guys, did you hear him saying that Jesus is sinless? Did you hear it?
Yes.
Okay.
So yes, now because his nature is sinless.
Okay, his nature. That's wonderful, guys. He has...
So hold on.
Mahdi, please. I give you time. I listen to you. So Jesus have a nature... A nature which is sinless. Isn't it? This is God nature? Isn't it God nature that he is sinless?
I mean, angels are sinless as well.
No, the Quran says no. I will show you.
Go ahead.
Okay. Here we go. And I want you to hold your word. Don't take it later. Say, I did not say that Jesus' nature is sinless. Okay, this is very important. Now, let us see. When the angels... They question the order of Allah. If you question the order of Allah, is that a sin?
angels do not commit sin. Like, what is a stupid thing in Islam? They do not commit sin.
Okay, let us see if this is true or not. Here we go. This is Quran. Chapter, you know, chapter like 2. Jibreel, chapter 2. Hold on, my friend. Hold on. Chapter 2. Verse number 30. Read it. Can you read it for us?
Let me see. Which chapter?
Chapter 2, verse number 30.
And indeed, when your Lord said to the angels, indeed, I will make upon the earth a successive authority, they said, will you place upon one who causes corruption therein and sheds blood, while we declare your praise and sanctify you? And Allah said, I know that which you do not know.
Okay. So the angels, they question the order of Allah, the decision of Allah, correct?
Sorry?
They question how smart his decision to create someone. When I say to somebody, are you going to create someone who would do mischievement? That's mean I'm questioning how smart you are, how right your decision. Are you correct? Okay. Is that sin or not?
But,
is that sin to question Allah?
Angels, wait. But angels in Islam, they do not commit like sins.
My friend, no, they do. I'm showing you this is Islam.
Mahdi,
I'm showing you Islam. This is Islam. I'm not showing you Mickey Mouse magazine. This is the Quran. So don't tell me in Islam, this is not true. Here we go. The angels themselves,
what
they are.
About such way?
I'm asking you, if I say to Allah, if Allah says to me, I am going to do this, and I say to Allah, are you going to do this, and this guy is going to do mischief, and isn't it, clearly, I don't like what you are saying, that you will create someone who will do mischief, and are you going to create someone who will do mischief, and isn't it, this is a question, how correct and how right the decision is, it's obvious. So the angels are questioning the righteous, or let us say, the right decision of Allah. What kind of decision you are making? You create someone who would do mischievement? Is that a sin to question Allah?
Is that a sin? For Allah, I don't know if that is a sin.
Suddenly he do not know. Suddenly take a note.
How come you question nothing
about Allah? He says to you, suddenly now questioning is not sin.
Just because Jesus is sin is
okay. Hold on. So what happened? Let us prove that this is sin. Then Allah, he told them, I know what you know not, correct?
Yeah.
Okay. Which means the angels are speaking without knowledge. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Okay. But challenging Allah without knowledge is a sin according to Islam. The Quran
challenging
says
challenging Allah.
Yes, because you are challenging Allah. You are asking, you are questioning his decision. Why you create this? Why you do that? That's a challenge. Okay, let us see if it's true or not. And then Allah, he wanted to prove the angels wrong. So what he did, he come with a very
stupid idea.
And he taught Adam all the names of all things. Then he placed them before the angels and he said to them, tell me the names of those things. If you are truthful, not right, the translation is false. It says sadiqeen, correct? Does it say in Arabic? In kuntum sadiqeen?
Yes.
All right,
yes,
thank yes. you. Guys, Allah said to them, if you are truthful, not lying, tell me the name of those things. So Allah accused the angels of what? Of lying, correct?
Wait, let me see. Which chapter?
The same chapter, chapter 2, verse number 31. In kuntum sadiqeen. So in kuntum sadiqeen, tell me the names of those. If you are telling the truth, when I say if you are telling the truth, it's mean either you are telling the truth or you are a liar. He did not say if you are
not committing sin.
Okay. Huh? Hold on.
What's the point of this?
The point is so clear. Allah, he said to them, if you are telling the truth, does it say that or I'm lying? In kuntum sadiqeen, yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, that's mean they are not sadiqeen.
Okay.
Okay, if someone is not sadiq, what is the opposite of it? Tell me.
But
don't butt me. I'm asking you that question. It, what is the opposite? I said to you, in kuntum sadiqeen mean, and you said it's mean if you are truthful. Okay, what is the opposite of this? If they are not truthful, what they will be?
If they thought they were truthful.
If they are truthful, he said, in kuntum sadiqeen, sadiqeen. If you are truthful, right?
Okay, but okay, maybe, what? Maybe so, the angels,
Maybe when Allah, he said to them, you are not sadiqeen, what does that mean?
Can you actually show me and real proof that angels are sinners?
My friend, here we go in front of you. I'm asking you, if Allah said to them, you are not telling the truth. Allah saying to them, you are not telling the truth. What does that mean? Translate. Does it say, in kuntum sadiqeen, if you are truthful, which means either you are truthful or you are not. So if they are not truthful, that will make them liars, correct?
What do you mean liars?
Why he used the word sadiqeen? He did not say if you are not mistaken. He did not say if you are wrong. He said sadiqeen.
He never called them liars.
He did. He says if you are telling the truth.
Okay, if you are telling the truth, but show me where it says they are liars.
Okay, but that's mean they are not telling the truth. If I say to you, if you are telling the truth, show me the proof. That's mean I'm accusing you of lying, my friend.
Correct? No, it doesn't mean you're accusing me of lying.
Hold on. So guys, I will go with you and I will show everybody in a second how Mr. Mahdi, he will bite his tongue. I will take the sentence as it is. Is that okay, Mahdi?
Okay, no problem.
Okay, and I will copy. Hold on. I will take the same sentence and I will paste the same.
Hold on.
Everybody will laugh at you in a second. With my respect to you, Mr. Mahdi, we are having fun here. I hope you have a sport spirit. Here we go. I will paste the same sentence in the Quran. In kuntum sadiqeen. Let us see what we will find. Horrible. Horrible news for you. In kuntum, if you are questioning what Allah He gave to our Prophet, give us your proof if you are sadiqeen, if you are telling the truth. Let us see the Muslim translation. Let's take it to different in English. Hold on. Here we go. Let us open another page. You see, Mahdi? You are defending a defendless religion, my friend. Hold on. Here we go. In kuntum sadiqeen, all over the Quran, it's mean if you are not a liar. Chapter 2, verse number 23. Is Allah accused them? Is Allah accused them that they are not, they are doubting is true, which means they are lying or they are truthful? Chapter 2, verse number 31. Chapter 2, verse number 94.
Chapter of Quran when we speak about that verse.
Here we go. Hold on. It says here, look, this is the translation. In kuntum sadiqeen, if you are sincere.
Yeah.
If I say to somebody, if you are sincere, that's mean you are not sincere, correct?
It doesn't have to specifically mean that.
Well, they refuse Muhammad. He is saying to them, you are mushrikeen. So they are sincere for Allah? He's speaking to the kuffar.
This is going to
prove that you are not being honest now. It says, here we go.
Mean, being,
okay, chapter
just
2.
Because I said, wait,
chapter
just
2, chapter said, 2, hold wait, on. Wait, chapter 2, verse 111. Chapter 2, verse 111, it says, produce your proof if you are truthful. Thank you very much. And so the same happened in the verse we are talking about, if you are truthful. So if they are truthful, those angels, they should provide answer which is a truthful answer, but they are obviously not truthful, which means they are liars. And let us prove now to you, because obviously you're trying to escape the problem. What happened to Allah to the angels after that? Because they are not truthful, Allah He ordered them. Hold
okay,
on.
No problem.
Allah He Can ordered I? Them. Allah He ordered them to bow down to Adam. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. Why He ordered them to bow to Adam? Is that because they were truthful? Hold on. The Allah He ordered them to bow to Adam.
I can't speak. You were speaking 99% of this debate.
No, I want an answer because you are trying to change topic to escape. You cannot escape with me. I'm Christian.
No. I'm not changing the topic.
I'm saying to you, why Allah He ordered the angels to bow down to Adam? Because they accused Adam untruthfully that he would do mischief, incorrect?
I don't care. This is not a topic.
What do you mean not the topic? We are proving to you that Jesus is holy and you are the one who said to me, that angels are
pure.
Hold on, you see, you see, Mahdi, you are the one who chose the topic. You are the one who chose the topic, and now you are in the corner. I just proved to you that according to Islam, according to Islam, according to Islam, spirit is not angel, obviously. And according to Islam, angels are not.
Angels are not
holy. So why you say to me angels are holy? I got you busted, because Allah, they commit sin, and this is why Allah is punishing them to bow down to Adam for accuse Adam falsely. Correct.
First of all, the Holy Spirit that's mentioned in the Quran is most likely Jibril.
Okay.
So don't lie.
Hold on. Thank you very much, guys. He just said it's most likely, but how it says holy, but the angels, all of them, they commit sin. And this is what the Quran is saying. Allah, he ordered all the angels, including Jibreel, because Jibreel is one of the angels, he is not an exception, to bow down to Adam for the false accusation against Adam. So how he's called holy, but he's not holy?
What do you mean a false accusation? It doesn't have to mean a false accusation.
Yes, so why Allah then? So why Allah, he said to them, I know what you know not. And then he said to them, if you
Allah
are right. Okay, hold on. Okay, you see,
Allah,
this is your Muslim translation. Abdul.
Mahdi. It doesn't mean
okay
that they lie. Or
no, they are lying. You see, the Muslim when translate, they say, if you are right. Right? This is your translation. But the fact in Arabic, and you agree, it says if you are truthful. If I say to you, if you are truthful, obviously I mean the opposite. You are not truthful. Are they truthful or not? I'm asking you. When they say that Adam would do mischievement, was the angels telling the truth or they were not telling the truth?
Sorry, can you repeat that?
When the angels, they say to Allah, are you going to create someone who would do mischievement and shed the blood? Were they telling the truth according to Allah in the Quran, or they were not telling the truth?
Wait, I'm really, really sorry. Can you please repeat that?
Oh, okay. Sorry. I will say it slowly. When Allah, he told the angels he will create somebody, and the angels, they said to him, are you going to create someone who will do mischief in the earth and shed blood? Were they, the angels, were they telling the truth, or they were not telling the truth?
They were being truthful, because we shed a lot of blood today.
Thank you very much, guys. This is an honest Muslim, so Allah was stupid, because Allah was opposing them. Yes, because look, Allah in the Quran saying to them, if you are truthful, hold on, a disaster happened. Mahdi is out of Islam. Listen.
Allah said, hold on.
Mahdi, you just said.
Because Allah said, Listen,
I will give you time to talk. You just said the angels are telling the truth. That means Allah is stupid. My friend, Allah, he did punish them for saying that. He said to them, if you are truthful.
Because Allah said, I know what you know not.
No problem. So they were speaking without knowledge. And you agree with me. 5 minutes ago, you said, yes, they are speaking without knowledge. Thank you. But now you just said, yes, Adam, he commit.
But he did
mischievement. Okay, hold on. Okay, so Allah, when he said to them, if you are truthful, why he's opposing them if he agree? You see? You are saying to me, you just admit
because Allah knows what they don't know.
Okay, but how Allah, he knew what they don't know, but Allah is wrong and they are right, because you just said, agreed, that yes, Adam, he did mischievement, and Allah, the whole story, he's saying that Allah
Adam,
will prove to them.
Adam did mischievement?
Yes, you are the one who said that.
Wait, what is... Where did Adam do mischief?
What do you mean? Isn't it the Quran says he ate from the tree, and then Allah, he said to him and to Eve and to Shaitan,
no,
get down.
The verse is talking about all mankind, because it says bloodshed and stuff
No. He said I will create a one person. He did not say I will create many.
Yeah,
he said
by
Khalifa.
That one person, where
Khalifa,
all mankind will come,
a caliphate, a caliphate. He did not say caliphs.
That's what
my friend
says.
You speak Arabic. It says Khalifa, right? Khalifa, one person.
That's what verse 31 says.
Okay.
Did Adam kill somebody?
Correct. No, but Adam, my friend.
So now,
if you go, hold on. If you go down just a few verses down,
exactly,
you will see that Allah.
So
hold on,
angels,
hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on.
Wait,
if you go down,
wait.
Listen.
Habibi.
I'm not Habibi. Don't call me Habibi.
Wait.
This is an insult. Listen.
But Satan caused them
to deflect. They're from expelled from them. So did Shaitan cause Adam to do mischievement against Allah? and Allah kicked him up from to the same chapter, chapter 2, verse number 36. Shaitan, but, he mislead them, and Allah, he cast Adam from heaven.
But verse 31 is the angels are questioning all of mankind. They were like, why are you
there's no mankind, my friend. There's no mankind yet. There's no man. There's no mankind. They are questioning Adam because he said, I will create a person. He did not say, I will create mankind.
But the angels, they ask about bloodshed. Did Adam bloodshed? Yes or no?
Adam did bloodshed?
The angels were like, why do you want to start this creation which will kill and, you know, do this sins?
Okay.
Hold on.
Let us go back to the verse. It says here, are you going to place therein the one who will harm therein and will shed blood while we are the one who praise and sanctify you? Okay. Adam, when he went down to the earth, what the first thing happened after Adam went to the earth?
My friend, this is talking about all mankind killing each other.
No problem. You see, I have no problem with that. But Adam, did they accuse? Okay, let's say, I will go with you. So according to you, they did not accuse Adam. They accuse all mankind. They do mischief, man. And you say this is true. So why Allah is opposing them? I will go with your logic.
Because Allah said, I know what you do not know.
Okay, what he do not know, that's mean they are wrong. He said to them, if you are truthful.
What do you mean?
Did he say to them, if you are truthful? Did he say, after they said to him, they will shed the blood? Did he say to them, if you are truthful, tell me the names of those things?
We already went through that. It doesn't mean liars.
Because if you are truthful, that means you are not truthful. And this is why he's challenging them to tell the names. He's challenging their knowledge. Their knowledge is wrong. And you are the one who said they are right. So Allah is wrong then, because he is challenging what? Why he taught Adam all the names? Tell me, please.
Can we please get back to the topic?
We are in the topic. We are in the topic. The angels are not holy, because we will go there when we finish this one. Why Allah, he taught Adam all the names? What was the purpose?
Okay, no problem. The angels are not holy.
No. I don't want you to say that. Okay. No. You see, we are not kids, my friend. This is very serious. A lot of Muslims live in Islam right now as we speak because of you. I want you to answer me. How? Okay, when Allah, he taught Adam all the names, what he was trying to prove? The angels are wrong.
I said, okay, no problem. No problem. Angels are
No. I don't. My friend, either speak to me as an adult or let us not to speak. Please. I respect you. I speak to you as an adult. Don't act like a kid. Why Allah, he taught Adam all the names and he asked the angels to tell the names? What was the purpose of this story?
Can we please get back to our topic?
Here we go.
I said, okay, no problem. Angels are sinners.
So, guys, he have to agree that Allah, he taught Adam all the names to prove that their knowledge is wrong. You do not know what I know. You are wrong. So, but he agreed that the angels are right. So the angels, according to him, they are not sinners, but according to Allah, they are sinners because they know what to know not. And they assume things, they accuse Adam falsely according to the Quran. And that's why Allah, he proved them wrong. And then the Muslim, they have to bow down to Adam immediately. After he asked them to recite the names and they failed, right away he said to them, angels, bow down to Adam. So it was a punishment, a penalty. Do you agree?
No.
So I'm allowing you to, nobody was able to speak as much as you do. But you are trying to avoid.
You still haven't proved Jesus God in Islam, even though Islam
is... No, we prove that because the angels are not holy. And here we go. You don't order. Okay, hold on. I will go with your logic. Guys, you are saying to me that Allah, he ordered a holy person to bow down to an holy person. Are you saying that?
Yes.
Thank you very much. Guys, did you hear it? Muslims believe that a person who is holy should bow down to a sinner.
That's because Adam was the first human. It's a prostration of respect.
What respect? Where it says I bow down as respect? Where it says that? You are fabricating things. This was a penalty for they acknowledge something which Allah refused. Allah don't accept what they said, and this is why he taught Adam the names, so he will show them that he knew the names. And here you see the story how stupid it is, Mahdi. Let us say your father, he called you Mahdi, and then your father, he saw me in the street and he said, do you know the name of my son? I say Ahmad. He said, no. I say Khaled. No. Hassan. No. And then your father, he said to me, with my respect to him, oh, If I tell you the name, I will prove to you that I am God. How? Because he is the one who named you Mahdi. Have you ever heard of a stupid story like this? I named the cat, cat, and then I ask you, what the name of this cat? You say dog, say no. Shushu, no. I call her, I named her Susu. So Allah, he proved to the angels that he is God by giving names to things.
CP.
So look what CP. We prove here. We prove that Allah is a fufu. CP. We prove that Allah is false. We prove that the angel story is funny and dummy, and even kids cannot accept it. And now we go back to Jesus. Can we?
No problem.
Okay. If the angels, they bow down to man, that means the man is higher than the angels. Do you agree?
No.
No?
No.
So guys, if a man, so why Adam don't bow down to the angels then?
Mean Adam don't bow down to, because the Allah ordered the angels to bow down to Adam.
Thank you. You are the
can
one who
please,
said to me.
Can
you are the one.
Jesus?
Okay, listen. I am the one who asked you why the angels they bow down to Adam. You said because of respect. So who is the one
okay,
who
no
bow
problem.
To who? The one who respect a person, he bow down to him. Adam never been ordered to bow down to the angels. That means you Muslim believe that Adam is higher than the angels.
What kind of a logic is that? Just because you
so why you bow down to why the angels bow down to a man? Why angels they bow down to a man who is a sinner? He was kicked out from heaven. What kind of logic this logic
because
is?
God, because God told them to do so.
Ah, and so we don't question. Here we go. See, because so you are saying, is it a sin to question why God he says so? He do so? Is it sin to question what kind of a stupid decision Allah is making? Is it sin?
No, Allah's not making a stupid decision.
I'm asking you, this is not a question. Is it sin if I question?
We're wasting so much time.
I'm not wasting time. I'm showing everybody how you Muslim, you go in circle. Is it a sin for me to question how Allah, he ordered the angels to bow down to a man with a sinner? Is that a sin to question his order?
Sorry, can you repeat that?
If I am questioning now, the legitimate order of Allah to order the angels to bow down to Adam. Is it a sin in Islam to question what kind of God he ordered his angels to bow down to a man who commits sin? Is that a sin?
Obviously. Yeah. Obviously, because you said, well, what kind of a God is that? Obviously, you are sinning.
Thank you very much. And this is what the angels, they do. The angels, they say to him,
no,
oh, here we go. No, here, oh,
God,
hold on. If we go back,
point.
No, here we go. If you go down, listen to this. He said, and when the Lord, he said to the angels, I'm going to create someone to inherit the earth. They said, will thou place in someone will do mischief, shed blood? So they are questioning what? Question, what kind of God are you? You are going to create somebody who is going to do mischief, and we are the one who worship you. So they are debating him. They are arguing with him.
Did you even listen to what I said? I said,
my friend, we heard you. Now we go back.
You are asking
we go back. Hold on, hold on. We go back to Jesus. And I remember what you said carefully. You said Jesus by nature is not a sinner. And you said because Allah created Jesus by B. Okay, I want you to show
yes.
me how Allah created Jesus by B.
Well, it's in chapter 3, verse 59. The reason we humans we are not created by the word be.
My friend, no.
So,
I'm asking you.
Sorry?
You see, you are quoting for me, chapter 3, verse number 59, where it says that Isa is the same likeness of Adam. Allah he said to him be, and he was. That means both Adam and Isa were created by the word be. Correct.
Yeah, and the reason why they were both created by the word be. It's because Adam had to be the first human.
Okay.
Because he cannot have two parents consummated with each
my
other.
My friend, Mahdi,
Adam. He had to be created specially. And
my
Jesus,
friend, Mahdi,
he is not originally
not
a
listening.
Human. He's a spirit which Allah cast down and
Mahdi, my friend, you are not listening. I said to you, show me how Allah created Adam or Isa by B. Can you show me the Quran where it says that?
Doesn't the Quran say that Allah created Adam by mud and then water and then he waited?
Thank you very
and
much.
Later he said B.
Where it says B? Guys, hold on. Guys, he just said that Allah, he made mud and he mix. How you make mud? You mix him with the with water, like dust with water, right? Correct.
Okay, but what okay. does it have to do with talking about?
Hold on, hold on. No, 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 no. He did not say B. He made mud.
He made mud.
Here we go. You are the one who said that he made mud, and then after he made the mud, he blew into the mud, and then that became Adam. So the first, how many steps we have? First, we have to bring water and dust, and then we fashion him. And then after we fashion him, we breathe into him, and then he became a creature. His name is Adam. What is the word B?
Well, it doesn't have to mention the word B because
no, it have to. No. You are the one who mentioned to me. Hold on. You are the one who mentioned to me. You are the one who mentioned to me that Allah, he said, Adam and Isa are the same. Both are created by being same B. But then when we check how Adam was created or Isa, we will find there is no B involved. Here we go. Read with me. It's chapter 15, verse number 29. And when I have fashioned, hold on, behold, the Lord said to the angels, I am about to create a man from sounding clay and from molded into a shape. So what Allah did, he made the clay and then he made a shape. And then after we fashioned the shape and then we breathed into him and then he became a human. Where is B?
First you see, of all, it doesn't have to be 100% detailed about.
No, it have to. It have to. It have to. Because hold on, guys, guys, go look at this. Look at this, guys. Okay, okay. Hold on. Maddie. I'm going to cook zucchini now. And you ask me, Christian Prince, how you cook zucchini? I say to you, oh, I said zucchini be cooked and be cooked. And then I post a video in YouTube where I am cutting the zucchini, cleaning the zucchini, putting water with the zucchini, adding whatever with the zucchini, adding oil and salt. And that is supposedly be. I mean, this is the magical word of Allah, be. And then we find that there's no be. He was doing step by step. What do I mean? What are we talking about? When Allah, he say be, when Allah, he say be, it's mean the person. Hold on. Okay, hold on.
Allah. Maybe listen. Without the word be, Adam and Jesus cannot be created.
What, show me what is the word be. Here we go in front of you. Did Allah say the word be?
in chapter 3, verse 59.
My friend, that is a contradiction for this chapter. Thank you very much.
The Quran said,
if this book is not from Allah, you will find a lot of contradiction in it. Thank you very much.
Imagine, like for example, Allah creating the sun, and the sun, Allah created the sun at the beginning, and then the sun doesn't have light or doesn't give heat, and then Allah says be, and suddenly the sun gives light.
Okay, show me where Allah, okay, hold on. You see a good example in the Bible. It says that God, he said, let be light, and light was. That's it.
Yeah, and Islam agrees with that.
In the Quran, and you are the one who mentioned chapter 41 and verse chapter number 79, which is horrible, how Allah took him 4 days to create the earth and the top of them. And not only that, when Allah, he created Adam, he created him Adam afternoon, correct?
Yes.
Okay, guys, you just said that Allah, when he created Adam, he said to him, be, and he was. But Adam, when he was created, Allah, he created him Friday afternoon, and Adam, he said to Allah, finish me before the sunset. Correct? Okay. Correct?
Let me see. Which source is that?
The same chapter we are talking about.
Let me see. Because I am not on YouTube. Just wait a little bit. Wait, the screen shows up. It's slowly coming up, man.
No problem.
Do you even have it in front of you, the hadith?
Which like hadith? Which hadith you want? We have many of them. Which one? We have endless.
Let me see.
We have endless. But anyway, let us do this.
Can you show me the text?
Okay, hold on. Let us do this. Give me a second.
When Allah created Adam, he breathed his soul into him. He sneezed, said, Alhamdulillah.
Just wait. I'm trying to find you. I'm just trying to find it in English so everybody can read, you know, not only me and you who speak Arabic. Okay, look like I have to go on. Let us see here to Ibn Kathir.
Is it Ibn Kathir?
It is in Ibn Kathir. It's everywhere. In Qurtubi, Al-Tabari, it's everywhere. Okay, hold on.
But is there a chain of narration?
Yeah, for sure, yeah. But anyway, you know what? Here we go. If we go to the tafsir where it says وكان الإنسان عجولا, chapter 17 verse number 11. Let us go to Ibn Kathir. All right, here we go. Let me wait for you on the screen a second. Do you see the screen?
Wait.
When Allah, he created Adam, and then Adam, he wanted to get up. When his soul was breathed into him, enter his body from his head downward, which reached his brain, he sneezed, and he said, Alhamdulillah, praise be to Allah. May Allah, he said to him, may Allah have mercy on you, Adam. And when it reached his eyes, Adam, he opened his eyes, and when it reached his body, and limbs start to stare at them, in wonder, he wanted to get up and before it reached his feet, but he could not. So he said to Allah, oh Allah, finish me before the night comes. Correct?
But doesn't it say that Adam was already, the spirit was already blown into him?
But it's proven to you that even according to Islam, even after he finished, after he made the mud and fashion, etc., and even after he breathed, still Adam is not finished. So why you are saying to me, Allah, he said be and he was. Adam saying to Allah, finish me before the sunset. He's worried. Allah is so slow. And the same, in the hadith Muhammad, he mentioned here, that Allah, he was
still created.
No, but he did not finish him. But you say, when you say be, yeah, my friend, when you say he said be and he was, when you say he said be and he was, that is not what it's mean, be and he was, because simply it's taking time. Okay, hold on. Did Allah create did Allah say to the sun be and it was?
No, I'm just giving an example. Like, imagine Allah creating the sun, and the sun doesn't give light or heat, or it's just a dead thing.
Mm.
And then Allah says to it, be, and it suddenly gives light and heat. Then that's what the word be means. It means he gave life. It's kind of that.
Okay, you know? No, hold on. No, Allah, he breathed into the mud in order to give life.
No, the life was just an example, like in order for that sun to work.
Oh, talk about Adam now. No, hold on. Because Allah did not say be to the light and it was, so you cannot name that example. Allah, He named one example only, Isa and Adam. So don't fabricate things. So Allah, He breathed into Adam, and yet Adam is still, even after the breathing, still he is not done. So how the word be will function? Obviously, it was a mistake of your prophet by saying the word be, because Allah, He did not create neither Isa or Adam by be. Now, Look what happened here.
I don't know what you're talking about.
No, you are the one who do not know talking about. If I say B, you see, did you watch cartoon? In cartoon, like in the guy who do magic, be mosquito, and the guy turn into a mosquito in a second. He don't go, and he want to put like some zucchini and some black label.
What are you talking about? He said by the word B.
No, he did not. As you see, he made mud, and then he fashioned them.
Chapter 3, verse 59.
My friend, okay, but this is contradiction, because as you see, Allah, He did not.
There's no contradiction. It's just not 100% detailed.
No, it is 100 details. Actually, this is the one with the details. This is the one with the details. No. Allah is showing you. Okay, here we go. Okay, hold on, guys. Look at the hypocrisy of Mahdi. He is saying that this one without details. When the fact this one is with the details. There's no being.
Denying facts. The Quran says Jesus is created. It's a period. He's created.
Where it says okay, isn't it the Quran says that Allah He broke, isn't it Allah, okay, hold on, you listen, isn't it Allah He said in the Quran that Allah He blew in the vagina of Mary? Did Allah blow in the vagina of Mary in order to make Mary pregnant? Yes or no?
Listen, Jesus is not eternal, except that fact in Islam He's not eternal. He's created, period.
Guys, you just said that Jesus have no nature of sin. And you just said that He is the Word of God. But isn't it the Word of God in Islam is eternal?
He is created by the Word of God, yes.
No, hold on. He is the Word of God. The Hadith does not say, hold on, okay, let me get you busted. The Hadith says He is created by the Word of God, or He is the Word of God?
He is the Word of God because He is created by the Word of God.
Guys, He is the Word of God. So how you say He is created by the Word of God? He is the Word of God. Okay.
I just explained.
Okay. No, you do not explain. No. Hold on. Are you the Word of God? Are you the Word of God? Are you the Word of God?
No, I'm not.
Okay. Is Adam the Word of God?
Yes.
Show me the Hadith says He is the Word of God.
Show me the
Hadith,
where it says
show me the Hadith or the Quran. Show me the Hadith or the Quran. It says He is the Word of God. Mahdi.
The description of Adam being the Word of God is in the Quran, but you want to show me where it says Adam is the Word of God? Okay, no problem. The reason why Allah doesn't
don't change the topic. Don't change the topic. Show me where Adam is the Word of God. You agree?
I will explain.
You see, so that means you cannot show me. This is why you need to explain. Can you show me a verse? Don't explain. The Quran says clearly that Jesus is the Word of God. Can you show me where the Quran says that Adam is the Word of God? Yes or no?
Is Jesus and Adam in Islam created by the Word of God?
You see, this is another question. Is Jesus the Word of God? You said yes.
No,
I said to you, is Adam the Word of God? Is Adam the Word of God? No.
He is.
Show me.
By His Word.
Okay, show me.
Okay, the reason why Allah never says that Adam is His Word, but just a description, is because Adam was never dwelt among human beings. Jesus was the first human.
Guys, Adam never dwelt upon a human because he was walking between monkeys. Well, isn't it Adam is our father and his children are a human being? He dwell between them and he lived for more than a thousand years according
Adam
to.
Is a father.
Isn't it Muhammad? Isn't it Muhammad who said that Adam, he did not dwell between a human being. Isn't it your prophet who said that Adam, he lived for more than a thousand years? So all this time he was dwelling between who? Between his children, human being. So listen, Abdul, you admit it. Everybody heard you. This is the important. Hold on. The important, you admit it. You admit it. Don't explain. Hold on. I will make a point. You just admitted that nowhere in the Quran it says that Adam is the Word of God. You just said that.
I did.
Okay. So guys, the Quran says Jesus is the Word of God, and nowhere in the Quran, and Mahdi is my witness, he said that, nowhere in the Quran it says that Adam is the Word of God.
Question,
do you think that Allah, He made a mistake for not mentioning that Adam is the Word of God? Huh?
Adam is the word of God.
Show me. You said nowhere mentioned the Quran.
Okay, in chapter 3, verse 59.
Doesn't say that. He says he's created by B.
Yes, so
but he is not. You see, no,
word.
You see, if I am created by something, doesn't make me that thing.
By the way,
so if okay, hold on.
Listen.
If Allah He said the sun be, that means the sun is the word be now.
Yes, the sun is Allah's word.
Okay, hold
it's
on.
Created by His word, therefore it's
no.
Word.
The sun is not Allah's word. Is Allah creation supposedly not Allah's word? You see, hold on. I will ask you, if there is anyone is called the word of Allah beside Jesus in Islam?
All tafsirs agree with my statement. You are the only Christian here.
I'm asking you, no. Did you Muslim call Adam the spirit of Allah? No. So that is the word of Allah, not from a human, he is coming from above. And this is what Jesus says in the Bible. I am coming from above.
Spirit.
Jesus, you just admitted that Jesus is coming from above, correct?
Allah created the spirit by the word be, and he cast down
hold
the
on,
spirit.
Hold on. You are fabricating Quran now. Where in the Quran says Allah created the spirit, and what is that? Listen, I asked you, you said, Mahdi, you said that Adam is not called the word of Allah. Adam is not called the spirit of Allah
because Adam is a human.
He's
the word of Allah.
Adam is the word of Allah?
Yes.
So why you don't call him the word of Allah?
What do you mean? I do.
No, you don't.
The word of Allah.
Okay, here we go. Show me one place Muslim they call Adam the word of Allah. Because now, if this is true, that means all the hadith you have, you Muslims, are fabricated. Because the hadith of Jesus is the word of Allah. Kalimatahu. Your prophet, he called Jesus. Did your prophet call Jesus?
To be more exact, it says kalimat. Listen. Hmm. It says kalimatahu, his word, not like. It just says that Jesus is his word.
He is the word. He is the word, and he is a spirit proceeding from Allah. Is that your Muslim translation?
It's not a spirit. Not a spirit which is part of Allah.
Okay, the spirit of Jesus is coming from where?
What do you mean coming from where? It's a spirit which Allah created.
Okay, where in the Quran it says Allah created the spirit of Jesus?
In chapter 3, verse 59.
Okay, a chapter. No, it doesn't say that. In chapter 4, verse 171, it says He sent it down on Mary. Why you are lying?
I explained it because Jesus is not a human.
Okay, no, hold on. Jesus is not a human who Allah created. What do you mean?
Because Isa originally was a spirit from above, which Allah created by the word be, and he and Jibril took this spirit and he blew it in Mary.
Okay, let's go with this. That's wonderful. So guys, Isa, before he was in the earth, we came to the earth, he was a spirit in heaven, correct?
Yes.
Okay. All mankind, they are not from heaven except Isa. He was a spirit. Okay. When Isa was a spirit, is that making him the Holy Spirit?
That's why. Listen,
hold on, no. Here. Hold on.
I'm gonna explain.
Is that make him Holy Spirit? Hold on. Is that make him Holy Spirit? When Isa was a spirit in heaven, is that make him Holy Spirit?
Holy Spirit?
Hmm?
What do you mean?
You are the one who said to me, Isa by nature is not a sinner. Correct?
Yeah, he's a pure spirit. He's
Thank
a,
you.
Because chapter
Thank
9,
you.
19,
so
Isa,
okay. Okay, so you are saying Isa was the Holy Spirit in heaven, and then he came down to the earth, and his nature have no sin. And now Isa became a man. Did the nature of Isa change after he became a man, or still he is Holy Spirit in the flesh of a body of a man?
I mean, like, for example, you guys believe Jesus was God, which took on...
Don't give me example, my friend. Don't give me example.
No, no, no.
Answer the question. The Holy... The Jesus.
I am.
No, I want the answer
problem?
To be...
I am explaining it.
No, don't explain. Jesus was a spirit, you said, and he was a Holy Spirit in heaven, and then he came down to the earth, and then he became a man. And now this Holy Spirit is inside the flesh of a human being. And the flesh of a human being still have the nature of no sin. And you agreed with that and you said that. Okay.
Yes.
So you, Jesus in as a human is not sinner. Jesus as a spirit is not sinner. Jesus is the word of God.
No. What are you talking about, Jesus? If that spirit becomes separate from the body, then that body becomes a sinner.
But there is no separation. How separation? Is Jesus separated from you?
It's not separated, but that spirit is
okay. The body. Okay, my friend, you are funny. So when Jesus was walking in the earth, he was walking with the spirit inside him, or he was walking like himself. He have no spirit.
That spirit was controlling the body.
Okay. It was inside him. Thank you. So now the flesh is holy because the Holy Spirit is inside Jesus. You are saying that, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. So guys, Jesus is a man by flesh. Yes, but he is holy by nature, for he have the Spirit of God inside him, and that made him.
Wait. What do you mean by saying he's a spirit of God? Do you mean he's a spirit which is a part of Allah?
You just said that this spirit is holy. So the only holy who is holy and he don't commit sin save God.
Listen, I want you to explain what you mean by Jesus is the spirit of Allah in Islam. What do you understand
you
by that?
You said that to me. The Quran says he is his spirit.
Yeah, but a spirit, like when you say Abdullah, a slave of Allah.
No problem. But you see, here the story is different. It's you who say that Jesus was not a human. He was a spirit, correct?
A spirit, but not a spirit of Allah's body.
No problem, but this spirit is holy, correct?
Yes, but Allah does not have a spirit. We don't believe in Trinity.
Okay, no problem. Allah does not have a spirit. That's wonderful. I will take a note of this. We will talk about it later.
Yeah, but so, Allah is what I believe. He's a spirit.
Allah is a spirit?
I believe God's a spirit.
But the Muslim believe that Allah is not a spirit.
Some Muslims, not all Muslims.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So so now you are saying you said Jesus is not part of the body of Allah, so you agree that Allah have a body too, correct?
Yeah, but not like our body or something like
that. No problem, that's wonderful, guys. Okay, let's do this. Okay. Is the body of Allah okay, so Allah now have a body and he have a spirit. Are they united? Are they one or two?
Allah doesn't have a body.
You don't have a body?
He's a spirit.
Oh, he don't have a body.
He doesn't have a spirit.
Okay. So how the Quran says Allah will uncover his shin?
Yeah, but shin, but not like our shin. It has nothing to do with it.
You see? Okay. His shin is different from our shin, but it's a shin.
Obviously.
So it is a body. Isn't it a shin part of the body?
No, but it's not. It's not like human body, like physical body.
So this is a three dimension body, but it's like a computer body.
Well,
what does that mean?
We cannot understand God.
This is not the question. Allah will show his shame.
What do you mean?
Okay. How you are saying Allah has no body when the Quran is saying Allah has body? So who are you?
Show me one place where the Quran says Allah has body.
Well, all the Quran. Here we go. If we, you know, how Allah he built the sky? He built it by hands.
Yeah, but this is the hands of God, not like physical hands.
Okay. Well, did your prophet?
What kind of interpretation is this?
Okay, did your prophet agree that Allah, he have five fingers?
I don't know. Even if that's true, it's not like our hands, but I want you to show me that reference where Allah has five fingers.
Okay, hold on.
The Quran does say that Allah has two hands, though, but it's nothing like our hands.
Hmm. Yeah, Allah has two hands, but his hand is not like our hands. That will not change anything, except that still he have hands. Thank you very much. All right.
Yeah, but doesn't the Bible like say Jesus is in the right hand of God?
Well, we believe in physical Jesus, not like you. We don't say this metaphorical, you know. Okay. Yeah, I like how you laugh like a cat. All right. Here we go. This is your prophet talking, and let us see. And this is Sahih. Let us show it in the screen. Read it.
It's the scream is coming up.
Hmm.
But if it really says that, then we're just gonna continue with the topic. Because I just wanted to the reference.
Okay, read it. Why your prophet? Why your prophet agree with the Jew? There is a video of your sheikh in the YouTube, by the way. He was speaking about this hadith, and he says, and this is why the prophet he agreed with the Jews that Allah, he has five fingers.
Yeah, let me see. I feel when the Jews came to prophet and said, I don't know about what place. On one finger and the others, one finger and other creation, on one finger, and he will shake them and say, I am the king, I am the king. Where does it say he has five fingers?
It says he carried the earth in a finger, the water and the land in a finger, the creation in a finger. What's wrong with you?
The earth on one finger, the waters and the land on one finger. Oh, okay, no problem.
Okay, forget about this one. What about this one?
Yeah, no problem.
What about this one?
No, I accept.
Okay, what about this one? Allah, he looked like Jesus.
No.
Okay, read it.
Okay, let me see. It's the screen needs to come up first. First of all, where does it say it's Isa? It's the Dajjal.
Okay, the Dajjal is the one who will take the shape and the look like Jesus. He will claim that he is the correct Messiah. Yeah, according to Islam, this is why
you're talking about in
my friend.
Okay, in Islam, Jesus is normal weight. He has red hair. He doesn't have curly hair. And the Dajjal is short. He has woolly haired, one eyed. Jesus doesn't have that. What are you talking about?
Okay, thank you very much, guys. What are you talking about, Christian Prince? So why Muhammad is afraid that you Muslim confused, you will think that this is Allah?
Because the Dajjal, he will come with a lot of power, and he will say, "I am God."
Thank you very much. But he is claiming to be the false Messiah, correct? He is claiming to be the true Messiah, correct?
Yes, but in correct. Islam...
okay, hold on. What is the difference between Allah and the false Messiah?
No. You are misrepresenting this. The reason why some people will be confused if this is Allah or the Dajjal is because the Dajjal will have a lot of power.
No problem.
He will say, "I am God."
And no problem. No problem. But what is the only way? What is the only way to recognize the true Allah from the false Allah, which is supposedly the false Messiah?
You misrepresented this. Allah is not curly haired, short head.
My friend, no problem. But what is the way? What is the way to recognize the true Allah from the false Allah? Read the hadith.
The reason why they will be confused is because
this is not the question. This is not the question. You see, my hadith. You are very good in avoiding like a little rabbit. Read with me. And he says, if you are confused about him, about who? About the false Messiah.
Yeah,
know that your Lord, hold on.
Listen,
know that your Lord is not one-eyed. Is not one-eyed. So how we can recognize between the fat boy who will come and Allah? They look exactly the same. The only difference between them, Allah is fat.
Listen,
Allah is fat. And he is short.
Listen,
hold on. Allah, and hinted and willy-haired. And one-eyed and one-eyed sightless. Neither protruding nor deep-seated. The only difference between him and the true Allah is one eye, and Muhammad is afraid.
Let me explain. The reason Muhammad said, if you are confused about him, is because the Dajjal will have a lot of power.
But you see, why he is okay? But he described only the difference between them is the eye. He did not say the power. He did not say Allah can do this. He can do that.
The reason Muhammad describes Dajjal on how he looks.
Exactly. You should know, but look what he said.
So?
He said, you should know that Allah is not one-eyed.
No.
Okay.
Says, if you're confused about it,
Mahdi, is the Dajjal coming in the shape of a man?
Yes.
Okay, so how the Muslim will be confused with him? How the Muslim will be confused with him? And how we can recognize who is the true Allah and the false Allah is the one eye.
You are misrepresenting this. I am not.
Okay, hold on. Mahdi, a second
just
ago.
Let me finish.
Okay, hold on. A second ago, you agreed that Allah has a physical body, correct?
No.
You
Allah
agree?
Is a spirit.
You agreed. We just showed you the hadith before that Allah has five fingers.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean that he is physical. He is a spirit.
Okay. Do you have anyone to support that?
Do you have anyone to support he's physical?
No, he's a spirit and he is not physical.
Okay, no problem. Then we both agree.
No, I'm asking you, what agree about what? Can you provide to me anywhere in Islam it says support what you say that Allah is a spirit and he is not physical?
No, but there's no proof to
it. Okay, hold on. So you are saying that Allah nowhere he said he is a spirit and you are fabricating a new Allah?
Nowhere does Allah say he's physical as well.
Oh, you are the one who said to me the Quran says Allah he created the earth by his hands. Allah have eyes.
Yeah, but
Allah
have a shin. Allah have a foot. It's not a physical hand. How can this be a physical hand?
So it is
how
what?
Can Allah create the universe by a physical hand?
So why Allah he says he have a hand if you don't have a hand?
He has a hand. He has a hand to grab.
Okay,
on
aren't you the one? Okay, Mahdi, aren't you the one? Guys, he have a hand, but it's not physical. How that can be? If either he have or he
what
don't.
How that can be?
Okay, do he have a hand? Okay, my friend, do he have a hand or not?
You should really learn the aqidah of the early Muslim schools because you have no idea what you're talking about. They explained this many times.
Explain to me. Are you what are you? What are you? Are you Mu'tazila? Are you what? What are you?
No, I don't follow this.
Okay,
like,
so don't tell me. Don't tell me. You should follow
schools,
the early. Give me the name of the early, so we can love together. So Allah have hands, and then you are saying his hands are not literally a hand. What they are?
No, it's not literally hand. It's just not a physical hand. It's not like a hand of ours.
Okay, when Muhammad he says Allah is not one eyed, how many eyes Allah have?
Allah doesn't have eyes.
But Muhammad, he said, is not one eye. This is how we recognize the guy.
So wait, let me ask you this. So if someone went to Muhammad and he said, how does Allah look? Do you think Muhammad would have said he's short, he's untowed, he's fully haired? Do you think Muhammad would have said that?
So why you Muslim, you say it is sahih?
See, so now you don't even believe in what you just said.
No, I don't believe anything I said. Anything I said to you about Muhammad is a joke. Because Muhammad saying those things, I don't believe what Muhammad said. Are you kidding me? I am here to prove to you that everything in Islam is a garbage. And you are saying to me, do you believe in this? It says, for sure I don't believe in all its garbage. But look, it says authentic. You're a prophet saying this is authentic.
I don't care if it's authentic.
When the Quran says Allah, he is having a hand. Who are you to say to Allah, oh, this is not real hand? Did Allah say it anywhere in the Quran?
I never said that. Okay. It's just not a physical hand.
Okay, did Allah say anywhere this is not physical hand?
Did he say that this is a physical hand?
Yes, because he said this is my. I built the earth and the heaven by my hands.
Yeah, but this is not physical.
How you know it's not physical? Give me a proof. I'm asking you for reference.
How do you know it's physical?
Okay, here we go. Like when your Allah, as an example, was filling up the earth, the hell, with the with people in hellfire, the earth, the heaven, she keep asking for more, and then Allah he put his foot in the hellfire, and the hellfire will say enough, because Allah's foot is big. What do you think about this hadith?
Right, it doesn't mean it's physical just because it can feel Allah.
Okay, so Allah he put his foot in hell, but his foot is not physical. What is the proof that this foot is not physical?
What is the proof it's physical?
Because it says there he put his foot. I mean, okay,
just
why?
Maddie,
I want to go with you. Why he call it foot if it is not a foot? Why he call it foot?
For example, when Allah says his hand, this is just a
hand. Forget about the hand. I like football. I like football. So why Allah, he says foot if he don't mean foot? If it's not foot.
I don't know. I can explain the hand. I can explain the hand,
okay.
But not the foot.
So Allah, he says foot. Okay, you said to me, and everybody heard you, that when the angels they tried to carry the throne of Allah, they could not because it's so heavy, correct?
Yes.
Is that the weight of the throne or the weight of Allah?
It's the weight of the throne.
Okay, so what is a spirit is doing in the top of a throne if it's a spirit? It's not physical. Is it because now you are saying to me the throne?
I told you before I don't know how this can be.
No, this is not a question now. Listen,
I'm not there.
The throne is a physical, and you prove that by saying it's very heavy, and everybody heard you. So it is proven to be physical. Okay,
so?
Why a spirit who don't have a physical body need a physical throne?
first of all, there's no proof that it's actually physical, the throne.
Second, you are the one who said to me that. You are the one who said to me, what's wrong with you? You are the one who said to me,
no,
the angels, they tried to carry the throne. The throne is so heavy. Allah, he helped them to carry the throne. You are the one who said that to me. It's very heavy. So it is a physical throne. And there's 8 angels in the look of a goat. And they would try to carry it. They could not carry it because it's so heavy. So it's proven to be that it's physical. So if the spirit is spirit, and Allah is on the top of his throne, which is a physical throne, and, you know, we have to find a body there. The spirit alone is doing there. What I mean, the spirit should be everywhere. When I say spirit, what spirit? I mean, is that physical? No. So what the spirit is doing in a throne, when that spirit should be everywhere? Okay. Is Allah spirit?
Listen, okay. Question.
Let me ask you, is Allah's spirit everywhere?
No.
Where it is?
Allah's above all creation.
That's not the question. Where is the spirit of Allah? Where is the spirit of Allah?
Can we please pick a topic?
Yes, we are talking about topic now. This is very important. Where is the spirit of Allah?
Hold on.
Okay, hold on. Do Allah come down every night?
Yes, but this is not like the way you understand.
Okay,
Allah
explain to
doesn't
me.
Come
how
down
Allah,
with like
okay, how Allah come
like,
down?
For example, like how Allah went to Musa. It doesn't mean Allah came down to him like actually he entered into his creation.
Hmm. How Allah he come
like,
down? Explain to us. Oh, we are listening.
Allah, like Allah himself, he can like make a way because Allah, God can do anything. He can like speak to us, and even though if we're in our creation,
okay.
But he like if we're saying God entered his creation because he spoke to Musa. That's very illogical.
My friend, Muhammad says Allah come down, correct?
Okay.
How Allah come down?
Allah is bigger than all of heaven.
Okay.
So
did your prophet say?
Did he come down?
Okay, did he say he come down? Did he say he come down? He descend down. He descend down.
He cannot come down. He cannot come down in a way you understand.
Oh,
he can
okay.
Descend in a way that
no problem.
Allah.
Explain it to me in a way I cannot understand. Allah come down where in earth or in heaven, correct? Where in heaven he go?
Where in heaven he talks to the angels and says, are there any of my slaves that I can forgive?
Hmm. But he come down where? But he said that from where? He said that from where?
I have no idea.
What do you mean you have no idea? Okay, hold on.
The angels, they will hear Allah.
Okay, hold on. You see, my friend. You are the one who says that Allah, he created... Allah, he created the earth and the heaven. And then he left himself above the throne, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, he was in the earth. Chapter 2, verse number 29. It says, read it carefully.
No.
Okay, here we go. Then, it is he who created for you all on earth. My friend, read. Don't give me an answer before you read. Chapter 2, verse number 29. Does it say that he created everything on earth and then he rose himself to the heaven? Does it say that or I'm making things up?
He created it, but it doesn't mean he was there.
My friend, no. It says he created for you everything in earth, and then he rose himself where to heaven. Does it say that, or I'm making things up?
Yeah, but this is just a saying from he created the earth, then he created, he fashioned the heavens.
But it says he rose himself to the heaven. He rose himself to the heaven. So what he was.
Yeah, but this is just a saying from when he finished the earth, he went to heaven.
Exactly. So he was where?
But he wasn't there.
Yes, he was not there. Thank you very much. He was in the earth because there's only heaven and earth.
What are you talking about?
Where Allah is located is either in the earth or in the heaven. So there was no heaven yet. So Allah, he finished the earth and now he went to heaven and now he created the heaven. So Allah, he rose himself to where? To the heaven. Where he was before he rose himself? Tell me.
First of all, that answer is not clear in the Islamic sources.
Not clear. So, guys, the answer for this is not clear. He gave me now the answer. The answer is not clear from... It's clear. It says he created the earth and then he rose...
Listen,
Mahdi. It says he created the earth and then he rose himself. Okay. He rose himself from where to where?
Listen, the Jews, they went to the Prophet.
Listen, don't change the topic. He rose him. He rose himself from where to where.
Are you gonna let me speak?
Yeah, I will let you speak. You need to answer. You are trying to escape the question. He rose himself from where to where?
You keep making new topics and new topics.
No, we are not. We are not, my friend. You see, I'm having all the patience in the world with you. You are talking like a kid, jumping like a monkey from a place to a place. Answer the question, please. Allah, when he, before he rose, okay.
Mahdi.
Why we cannot? Yes, because you are the one who said Allah don't have a body. We are trying to prove to you that he is inside his creation. And here we go. Allah, okay. Then, my friend. Okay, then answer the question. Allah, when he created the earth and there was no heaven, where was Allah?
Listen. The hadith you showed me before said that Allah, he will wrap up.
Take care. We have enough fun. I don't know how many people will leave Islam because of you. Now you see and you are a clear witness that Muslims, they have no idea what this garbage is about. It's called Islam. Everybody, he's giving you his own guessing. Everybody fabricating his own answers. And everybody is trying to come to his own interpretation because Islam is stupid. Why you are calling me Mahdi again? Why you are calling again?
Why you hang up?
Because you are a kid, you will not answer. I want an answer. Are you going to answer chapter 2? Chapter 2, verse number 29. Be a man.
Wait.
Okay. When Allah created the earth.
So, listen, Habibi. Let's speak a new topic now. So
No. We need to finish it. We cannot just escape this. This is horrible. I want you to answer. No, I am speaking with you for almost 4 hours, man. I want you, please, be honest with me. And here, Allah, he created the earth before he go to heaven, where he was.
Christian friends, we cannot understand the nature of Allah because the Jews, they went to Muhammad.
That is the answer. We cannot understand the nature of Allah. Okay. What? Don't call me back. You call me back, you will say we don't understand the nature of Allah. So why you are calling me to explain to me the nature of Allah if you don't understand the nature of Allah? I mean, have you ever heard of a silly answer like this? We don't understand, brother, the nature of Allah, but I'm going to explain to you the nature of Allah. But me, myself, I don't understand the nature of Allah. But yet I'm going to explain to you the nature of Allah, which nobody understands his nature. Thank you, Mahdi. You can call me later. I have enough for today. I mean, I have headache because of you. I don't know how many people will leave Islam. Now, for those who they are from Indonesia who download the video, I apologize. The video became so long. I think if one of you guys can download the video, make it short only for the topic answering this insane. So I don't know how many Indonesians live abroad. They have better internet. We don't want to make it so long for them. All right. But as you see, we just proved something very important, that even a Muslim, he cannot deny that Jesus is from above. And that in total agreement with the book of John, chapter number 1, verse number 1, he is the word of God, but the word of God is God in Christianity. Muslims, they believe the word of God is not created, but it's not God. And that makes them have two divine, which is very stupid. They claim that they believe in one God, but yet now they have two divine. His word and Allah are not one, but yet none of them is created. Secondly, he admitted that Jesus by nature is sinless. By nature is sinless. Then we need to ask ourselves, what is the nature of a sinless man? Must be the nature of God. Because it's proven that there's no man but he commits sin. It doesn't matter what his name. Prophets, doesn't matter who they are, they commit sin. Even his prophet said, "Kull ibn Adam al-Khattah," every son of an Adam is a sinner. This is why Jesus is not the son of Adam. For he is sinless. And that destroys Islam. In order for Jesus to be sinless, he has to be God. Because human is sinner. We sin. I sin, you sin. All of us, we are sinners. Even the Quran confirmed that angels are sinners. And this is why Allah, he punished them by bowing down to Adam. For they accuse Allah of creating something would do mischief and questioning his decision about how righteous it is. So we have a very good time with Mr. Mahdi, and Mr. Mahdi can call me again. I'm here for 4 hours almost. What is the time now? Oh boy, it's 4 hours, almost 4 hours. Always we run, my friend, always we are running. you idiot, the guy, he's just saying, let us change the topic. Did you see? Are you stupid or what? Your Mahdi, he was saying, let us change the topic. He is the one who's running, the one who wants to change the topic. Oh, no problem. I forgot you are Abdul. Yeah. Anyway, so we have a really great time. I'm very thankful for Mr. Mahdi. He called me, and I wish he would call me again, because I believe that this person, he will leave Islam sooner or later, and his family will leave Islam, and his people will leave Islam, and the whole world will leave the garbage of Muhammad, the man who promised you endless private part, the man who promised you killing people will take you to heaven, the one who promised you bloodshed is the way of salvation, the one who promised you that God is a pimp, he make you believe that there is a heaven like Las Vegas, a casino full of girls, who they are very little young, and they have big breasts, and a lot of rivers of wines, and whiskey, and black label. That is disgusting. That is not a promise of God, my friend. Always, always, you will find some truth in the Quran. Some truth. And let me find you some truth in the Quran. Look what the Quran said, trying to copy the Bible, trying to copy actually Paul himself. The thief Muhammad trying to copy Paul. Let's see. Paul, when he said, our great fathers, and one of them is Paul, when he said, a drunkard will not go to heaven, Muhammad, he tried to copy it. Those who do gambling, they will not go to heaven. The filthy Muhammad copying Paul. When Paul, he said, this is satanic, Paul is telling the truth. And then Muhammad, he promised you exactly what he said, it is from Satan to be in heaven. Look, the coward Muhammad. He just said that all those things are from Satan. So how come all those things will be in heaven? Do you see it? How those are from Satan, and in heaven we have what Satan have, what Satan he provide to us. So Muhammad was trying to copy Paul, who said the drunkard will not go to heaven, the gambler will not go to heaven, the sinners will not go to heaven, and then Muhammad, he promised you in the name of God, all of those things. You will be sitting in the heaven, surrounded by virgins who they are naked, wearing see-through clothes. And not only that, Muhammad, he exaggerated in his lies, because he knew that the Arab are racist, they love white women. So he exaggerated how white they are. So he promised them that you will see women who you can see the marrow of their bones. This is how white they are. For Muhammad is mentally sick person, promising the Arab man, the dream of an Arab man, a woman, she is extremely white. Look at this. They are so beautiful, transparent women. Transparent houris. You will see the marrow of their bones. How this is can be from God? How this is be? How can be godless God in the same time? This is godless promise. Why God want to make women see through? Why the promise fit with the dream of the Bedouin man who is have obsession with women who they are white? And if you wonder how your wife in the heaven will look like, my friend, I will provide you with a hint. This is how she will look like. Let me show you before we go. This is the promise of the man, he called himself Muhammad. This is your wife in heaven. You will see the marrow of their bones. How disgusting, how stupid. this is God? If this is God, what is stupid is? How a human being believe in such a garbage? I mean, how small our brain is. A mosquito have better brain than a human being sometime. This is God? Oh man, look how beautiful she is. Oh man. We will see the marrow of their bones, brother. Brother, are you getting horny, brother? Are you getting hot, brother? Brother, did you see this position, brother? Look at this, brother. Unbelievable, brother. The promise of Allah. Oh, brother, don't forget to see this one, brother. Oh, no. What about this one, brother? Oh, no. What about this one, brother? Oh, no. What about this one, brother? Brother, convert to Islam immediately so you can get this. Very sexy. Look like Muhammad, he think we are a bunch of dogs and we are hungry for bones. I mean, how in the world there's a person, he claimed to be a prophet of God, and he promised his followers women who we can see the marrow of their bones. Why? Why we need marrow? Why we need bones? Let me post the reference for those. I don't know if the admin is posting the reference. And as you see, this is sahih. The Muslim, the Muhammadan cannot say this is not sahih. This is sahih, brother. Authentic, really the authentic promise coming from the mouth of Allah right away. Bones. I invite you all to convert to Islam immediately so you can see the more the bones. Don't you like bones? Get the bones and say shahada. Very beautiful, very sexy. And by the way, you will never be worried about your wife eating your hamburger, because now she cannot hide it, even if there is many, because you can see through. If she say to you, it's not me who ate your hamburger, you say, liar, I see it there. And this is the benefit of having such a thing. So beautiful. Very beautiful. And this is the proof that Muhammad is a prophet of God, because this is godly promise. No other God can provide such a woman. Only Allah. And me myself, as a single, I have to admit I'm very much tempted. And actually, I'm collecting pictures of X-ray of women, for this is the dream of my life in the heaven. If I go in the airplane and the police, they found with me a pictures of X-ray of women, I will say to them, my name is Dr. Zakir Naik. Brother Fitar, I was in the hospital, and then I went to the airport, and then in my way, the police, they take the katam, and they tell to me, open your katam. I open my bag, and they see a lot of slide and a lot of TV have women with their X-ray. And they are in a sexual position. And they say to me, what is this? I say, this is science. I could not tell them that this is the promise of Allah is coming from heaven. Because if I say to them, they would laugh at me. And I took advantage because I'm a director, so they will believe me. And I told them my ID, I'm Dr. Zakir Naik. And it is very true. And then when they put the light in the TV, brother, all the airport, they start seeing women and they are in the X-ray. And by the way, when women, they are in X-ray, they have no panties. Exactly, sir. Yes, if you do X-ray, you will look without panties. Praise be to Allah. So Allah promised us when we go to heaven and those infidels, they laugh at it because they are stupid and crazy and because they cannot believe how amazing Allah is. This is from the promise, the mercy of Allah. The mercy of Allah that we will have women who we can see no panty. There's no need for panty there. Women will be without panty. They are X-ray. You know, you see, like, that's it. There's no need even to take off her clothes because you can see through. I mean, what are we with our time? In the heaven, and women, they are wearing clothes? That's stupid. So Allah will make them like X-ray. You look, and you are like a Batman. Like, you know, you can see everything. Very beautiful. And very sexy, And you know it. And with this, I want to say thank you all for being here. May the Lord bless you. And I want to say thanks for all those who support us in what we do, by everything, by downloading, by translating, by donation. We appreciate you all. And I pray that the Lord always will open the eyes of those who have eyes. And I believe that you don't see because you decide to make yourself a blind. And I am not. Glory to the Lord, the one who opened our eyes. Glory to the Lord, the one who sent us someone like Mahdi, who admitted that Jesus by nature is sinless, perfect, never commit sin. So then I asked myself, why this guy is following a filthy man like Muhammad and not the one who have by nature no sin? Which means no sin can take him, no Satan can deceive him, no evil can make him a fraud. Perfect, the perfect Messiah, the perfect being who no one like him, who said, I am the truth, I am the Alpha, I am the Omega, I am the life, I am the resurrection. And yet the Muhammadan, they say to you, where Jesus says, I am God, worship me. We follow the sinless name, the sinless person. His name is holy, his act is holy, his miracles is amazing, his teaching is beyond wisdom. That is my Lord. Who is your Lord? Is the one who provide you women, who they are X-ray women. Stupid promise from a stupid Bedouin man who do not know how he can seduce his followers, tempt them in a very trashy way, savage way. I am an Arab, yes, but I'm not stupid, so Muhammad cannot deceive me. For I know the truth, and the Lord, he said, the truth will set you free. Thank you very much. Thank you for your support. Thank you for your help. Thank you for your translation. Thank you for your donation. And thank you, Lord, for all this big family who they are surrounding us to learn the truth, to share the truth, and to save the Muslims, which we love them. We don't hate them. Never hate the Muslims. Love the Muslims. They are poor people, need your help. Show them the love of Christ. We are here to defeat the devil Muhammad, not to fight with Muslims. They are victims. They are poor people. They've been lied to. They've been deceived. And Jesus said, I came for the sick, not for the healthy. So be a doctor who help a Muslim so he can come back to Christ. Don't be against him. Don't be an enemy. Be a friend. Be a brother. Be someone who can help, not someone who destroy. Muhammad is a destroyer, for he is the devil. We are here to build a family with all the Muslims so we can be the family of Christ. And one day, all of us, we will be family in heaven under one name, Christ the Messiah, the truth, the Alpha, the Omega. And by his name, I leave you in peace. Thank you, and God bless you all. Take care.